Peter Jackson, VFL Live.
He's all on his own, he seals it!
Right foot kick from 55! The big fella's got it! The big fella's kicked it!
They're
no
right
way!
That is highlight reel right there!
On Aussie Digital, streaming live through vfl.com.au and on the Red Time Sport iPhone app, this is Peter Jackson, VFL Live.
As we welcome you to Preston, the Preston City Oval, the home of the Northern Blues, and it's great to be here as well on Peter Jackson, VFL Live, all around the place, video streaming through vfl.com.au, Red Time Sport iPhone app as well. And plenty to get through in our preview this afternoon. It is the Northern Blues taking on the Casey Demons. Yes, that's right. If you're just tuning in to the VFL for the first time, no longer the Casey Scorpions. They're aligning with Melbourne in an even bigger way, and they are the Casey Demons. The Peter Jackson VFL Development League was won earlier today by the Northern Blues. A narrow win, 71-54. Over the Casey Demons, and we're looking forward to a good day. Hazy conditions, the fog lifting from earlier this morning, and we should say from the outset, a happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there. It's a special day for them, and I think there are a few mothers in the crowd today hoping to see their sons play pretty well. We've got the results from yesterday to get through. We'll take a look at the ladder as well. There are some other big games to come today in the Peter Jackson VFL. So plenty to look forward to on Peter Jackson VFL Live. I've been back at this ground for quite some time, but Michael Leeds, you were here last year, as I recall. Hello to you.
Good afternoon to you, Pete, and to all of our listeners, and to all the mums. Happy Mother's Day. Hope you're enjoying it. Yes, it was quite a close contest, actually. I was here last year to watch the Pies and the Blues, and it was a real throwback. There was plenty of participation from the crowd. And I dare say that with both these teams' AFL squads going really well and on the path to improving their position in the competition, that all the fans of both Melbourne and Carlton will be down here watching what's next, who's coming through, who's playing well, who might be throwing their name up in front of selectors. And an interesting start to the year for both these teams. I think we're sort of used to Casey just rolling on and winning and winning and winning, and certainly not in any trouble. But, yeah, three losses out of their first four games, just the one win against North Ballarat, albeit by 45 points. I think they'll be keen to get their season rolling.
Well, they will be, but for the Blues, three in a row. Yeah. They're particularly strong the last couple of weeks that I've seen them, particularly against Coburg and then obviously against Collingwood last week. They were particularly good, and they're building a nice side here as we look down out on the ground to this beautiful ground, the Preston City Oval, and we see the Development League, the Casey Development League team just warming down in front of us, in front of our man on the boundary today. He's actually on the field. He's the only one on the field at the moment. Glenn Hill, good afternoon to you. You were getting seriously tempted by all the footies just going past you there.
Oh, certainly was, Pete. Wouldn't mind a kick. It's perfect conditions today.
It is. No real breeze. It's been a very still weekend.
Yeah, there's really no breeze to speak of at the moment. Just if anything, just a little bit slight coming across the ground towards the grandstand. But the conditions are absolutely fantastic for a great game of footy today, and I think we'll get one.
I hope so, as the umpires make their way out onto the grounds. We're about 10 minutes away from the opening bounce. Let's take a look at the results already from this round of the Peter Jackson VFL. Round 5, Essendon, 17-14-116. Did the double over the Cats in the VFL and the AFL. 8-7-55. Boyce and Mark Liu and Bell Chambers with 3 goals each for the Bombers. And James Cheetah's 3 goals for the Cats. The up and down yo-yo season of North Ballarat continues, not in terms of win-loss, but in terms of margin. And they got belted again yesterday by Williamstown up at Eureka Stadium. 17-21, 123 to North Ballarat, 4-8-32. Sipos and Masters with 4 goals each for Williamstown. And North Ballarat anchored to the bottom of the table, 34.79 their percentage. It doesn't make for good reading. They were competitive against Sandringham the week before, and then they have the blowout. So next week, they'll be back to being competitive again when they take on Werribee at Eureka Stadium, you would think. Collingwood ventured up to the beautiful town of Wangaratta, and Werribee got them, 17-10, 112 to 15-11, 101. A good performance here by Werribee. to get the win narrowly there. And the Channel 7 game yesterday, Port Melbourne 17-9, 111, defeating Footscray 12-9, 81. Conway with four goals, Haratuku and Lar with three goals each for Port Melbourne. And a couple of multiples there for Footscray as well. Today, Box Hill Hawks taking on Richmond. That match should be close to being underway. Actually, they're probably midway through because they've got a Swiss Wellness VFL women's game to follow that match at the Box Hill City Oval. And Coburg taking on Sandringham. That's the match being played just up the road at Bell Street. The ladder, as it stands, heading into those games today. Port Melbourne on top, 5-0, sitting 20 points. And they're a game clear of the Box Hill Hawks, who obviously have that game in hand today, 4-0. Then comes Williamstown and Footscray on 3-2. The Northern Blues could jump over the top of them today if they manage to get a win. They're 3-1. Also, Sandringham sitting 3-1, and Werribee sitting 3-2. And rounding out the eight at the moment, Richmond 2-2. And then from there, we have Essendon and Geelong on 2-3. Casey with the game today, 1-3. Collingwood sitting at 1-4. Coburg 0-4 on the season. And North Ballarat 0-5. So we've got a leader. We've got the Port Melbourne side. Box Hill could be there. A couple of undefeated teams by the end of round five.
Yeah, an important game this one too, isn't it? Richmond and Box Hill at halftime, as you mentioned, that game underway earlier this afternoon. 8-10-58, the Tigers leading Box Hill 6-4-40. And Box Hill kicked the last two of the second term. So it was a significant lead for Richmond, but it's just been cut down to within three goals for the Hawks.
Well, I don't think we're too surprised by the form of the Box Hill Hawks, but I reckon Port Melbourne Hilly have been the surprising team, and more so considering that the problems that they had in the pre-season in terms of off the field and all the financial dramas and difficulties that they've had, the fact that they're getting the job done on the park is testament to the strength of that side.
It certainly is, Pete. I watched the game yesterday and I thought they were outstanding against a quality opposition in Footscray, and the way they've recruited in the off-season, they've really addressed a lot of the problems that they had last year. They've got some injured players returning to the lineup this year, and that certainly helped as well, and a couple of old stages back on the scene as well. I think we talked about this a little bit last week. I think at the moment they're the team to beat in the competition. They've shown against different varying qualities of opposition over the first 5 weeks of the season that they can take on all comers and all styles of football. So at the moment, they're best poised to finish certainly top two or top four.
If we roll back a number of years and we go back to a season where they had a start like this, they went on and didn't lose a game all season. Yeah. They're on track for that again.
They are. And
I don't want to go too early here. I know it's only round five, but
They've certainly got the right man in charge there, obviously, as well, with Gary Ayres, and he's been a loyal servant to the club since he arrived there. And they certainly, the boys certainly get behind him and they play for him, and there's a lot of passion in the Port Melbourne Football Club, and it's great to see. It's great to see a standalone club playing so well this early in the season.
Yeah, it certainly is, and we're certainly looking forward to that continuing next week. Port Melbourne take on the Casey Demons. That's a Saturday night game, 7 o'clock bounce down at Casey Fields. Our match, by the way, Williamstown and Richmond at Burbank Oval, the only game of Peter Jackson VFL being played on next Sunday. But looking through some of those results as the Blues make their way out onto the Preston City Oval here as we slowly move ourselves into preview mode. I mean, Essendon getting the job done over Geelong, Williamstown, that was an expected result over North Ballarat, and, you know, the Werribee getting some momentum going. The degree of difficulty that Werribee has, being this nomadic team that's playing a series of grounds for their home games, the fact that they're actually managing to string wins together and being on the positive side of the ledger is an encouraging sign at 3-2.
And if they can just get somewhere near the mark come finals time, I don't think it'll be the worst thing. I think they'll be happy that they've travelled everywhere. No ground, no conditions will bother them. They'll know that they've conquered it all. And I think if you're looking for an upside as a Werribee fan, there might be the fact that they haven't had that home ground advantage throughout the year, because it would be, I mean, they're capable, but it would be a big effort to finish in that top couple. Mm. So they may not get the benefit of that anyway. And I'd be interested to speak to the authorities down there and see what they're thinking of it all at the moment, because they've certainly proved that they've got some mental strength to get over all that.
Well, they certainly do, as The captains are making their way into the middle of the ground. The toss of the coin. Tom Wilson there for the Northern Blues. And the two number ones, Jack Hutchins, making his way into the centre of the ground too. And Hilly, you're down there. The toss of the coin. So it looks like Tom Wilson won the toss there, Hilly.
Tom Wilson won the toss, and he'll be kicking to the right of screen.
In this opening quarter, the city end of the Preston City Oval, as opposed to the market end of Preston City Oval. It's a beautiful ground, and as you said, Hilly, this ground is in pretty good nick, actually. Looking at the middle, that can get a bit choppy as the season goes along. It's actually looking okay from this far away.
It certainly is, Pete. It's quite firm. They're just testing the bounce at the moment, the umpires, and yeah, the ground condition's quite good. It's a little bit choppy, I suppose, on the wings, which is to be expected after a couple of months of football. So, yeah, you would say overall the ground's in really good condition, and we've got perfect conditions in terms of weather today.
Well, not only do they play Peter Jackson VFL here, they play the TAC Cup here too. So the Northern Knights, their home ground is here at Preston. They play plenty of games here.
I think they might have had an interleague game yesterday as well, so it's a pretty popular venue amongst the local community.
Well, the Northern Footy League finals are played out here. So it does get a lot of use, this Preston City Oval. Taking a look at the two teams today, a couple of key outs for both teams. Sam Wiedemann obviously was named on Thursday in the Casey team, but played for Melbourne in their big win over Adelaide last night. Mitch White not playing today as well. And looking at the Northern Blues, I guess the player out, or the biggest name, I guess, is Harry McCready, number 34. So we take a look at the two teams out there. We're not too far away from a start. The Demons are in a huddle, and the Blues are still going full tilt on their warm-up. They'll be told to get a move on because we're actually only 2 minutes away from the match actually getting underway.
Maybe they're backing in a shorter dress pre-game, Pete. They certainly look well and truly into their warm-up, don't they?
We've also got a couple of AFL games to look at today. The first game for premiership points in China a little bit later on, the Gold Coast and Port Adelaide. And it's Richmond and Fremantle, the early game at the MCG. And we'll be keeping an eye on that throughout the afternoon and getting a score for you in that game, which is well underway, getting underway at 10 past one. And it's Fremantle leading by 3 points as they're 14 minutes into the second quarter, 4-4-28 to 4-1-25. So the team's making their way into position now. Here on Peter Jackson VFL Live. Hello, wherever you're joining us on the stream through vfl.com.au, the video and audio streams, or through the Red Time Sport iPhone app. It's great to have you here. Good crowd building up too in this magnificent grandstand, this historic grandstand at the Preston City Oval. And we're not too far away from the opening bounce.
Pete, good to see Brayshaw back out there for Casey. He's had a real tough time of it, missing some footy with some concussion battles, but good to see him out there, as well as the assurance from the club that he's going really well. So some positive news for D's fans and Casey fans alike.
Jack Trengove also in front of us here on the centre wing, as the Blues players now get themselves into position. And we're about to get this one underway. It's the Northern Blues and Casey at the Preston City Oval. Round five of the Peter Jackson VFL. Looking at the initial ruck contest, it looks like Mitch King will go up against Andrew Phillips. And all is in readiness now. Umpire holds the ball aloft, and we're set for a start. The Northern Blues and Casey. Peter Jackson, VFL Live.
The Blues coming into this one on the back of three in a row, looking to add number four. Casey, they need a win. Phillips knocked it down from the middle. Neil Bullen first hands away to Kennedy quickly through the middle. Little handball over the top, asked a bit and got a good answer. Handball fired back. This is well worked out the back, and that's nicely done to the half-forward flank where Kennedy Harris comes up and takes it on the chest. Looking for an option inboard. Now, it's interesting. He's just going to square them up. Moncrief takes the mark. Again, he's looking to go across the ground. Dangerous. Kerr got a hand on it. Chance for the Blues to get going early. He's 55 from home. He squares it up nicely to a hard-working lead. The mark isn't paid, but the free kick will be to Jax. And the use of the footy across halfback just coming undone there for the Demons. It's going to take me a while to get used to that. Demons rather than the Scorpions.
Scorpions, yeah.
You'll have to forgive me, Casey fans, as we make our
way
into this one.
You're lucky you're not calling them Springvale.
Yes. Well, they all fit, don't they? All part of the magnificent history of this wonderful Peter Jackson VFL competition. And Jax is going to take the kick. He's 5 in from the boundary, 35 to cover. It's a nice looking kick. Beautiful start for the Blues. They're 1-6. Casey yet to score, and we've gone 2 minutes in the opening term.
Well, great start. Gee, don't turnovers cost you in the modern game these days? It's just, you see it at all levels of football. That ball gets turned over and instantly you get the goal scored against you. There's so much pressure now.
He was ambitious, wasn't it? Use of the
very foot.
Both kicks, really. The first one was dangerous and the second one was just a little too dangerous.
So ball back in the middle. The home team on the board first. 1-6. Playing no score. Phillips again do the ruck work and having it to himself too. The ball to ground. Gent coming through. He lost a handle on it. Ends up with the Blues. Polson just trying to get the ball away. No one could get clear. And the umpire will come in and throw the ball up. James Munro there had footy in his hands for Casey.
We were talking pre-game, boys, that certainly the bigger players are for the Blues are the ones to look out for today.
As we see there, Brayshaw taking one head high, and that's not good news because he's staying down. Meanwhile, play continues on. Leading in the race is Bailey Fritsch for Casey. He's taken over the line. We'll have it thrown in. But let's go all the way back down the other end of the ground to Angus Brayshaw, who copped a knock in that contest and is taking a while to get up. As we wait for this ball to be thrown in, doesn't appear to be in a good way.
No, he's in the hands of physios. He didn't look like he was knocked out, but he certainly looked slow to get up to his feet.
It's the ball here, Bokhurst setting his teammate running. Is the kick going long and high?
He's coming
inside
off,
inside 50. Yep, keep an eye on that, Hilly. Here's another shot at goal. Working his way, Gallucci bouncing footy. Missing, bounced the wrong way. And through for one behind as Angus Brayshaw slowly makes his way off the ground. 1-1-7, plays no score. Early stages, opening quarter of this one. And Hilly, right in front of you, you keep an eye on what's going on as Harms takes the mark for Casey.
Yeah, this is the story, Hilly. You stay with that, mate. We're with you.
He's actually just walking through the direct line of play here. This is very dangerous.
So a long ball gets it to the wing. There's not going to be a mark. Numbers out the back for O'Shea for the Blues. Got it away. Pickett back to O'Shea by hand. He's going to release off halfback. We'll stay with Hill in just a moment. The ball's coming right to where Brayshaw is coming off the ground. He doesn't look well. No. Ball inboard for the Blues. I'd almost like to see the game stop, but it has to go on for the moment. Wilson has it at 55 out. Sets it to the top of the square. There's a fly from the back. Jackson couldn't take the mark at ground level. Chance for the ground level is there's no handball that's going to work for the moment. It's knocked over the line. Hilly, with you as this one goes over the boundary line.
Angus Brayshaw going straight into the rooms and looks, unfortunately, very groggy.
Oh, you talked about him pre-game, Leetsy.
Shocking news.
That's not great news at all. As the ball's tossed back in this opening quarter, it was barely a couple of minutes old, and then that happens as we see a quick kick out of the pack, partially smothered, trying to get onto it is Collis. He's got a player in support. He's Gent working it up the line. Tringo picking up now as his jumper ripped off. Ball heading to the line goes over. We pause. The umpire says throw it in. We'll give you an update on Angus Brayshaw when we can get it from Hilly down there on the boundary line. But as you mentioned, straight off and straight into the rooms. There's the ball to be tossed back in on 50 for the Northern Blues, doing all the attacking in this opening quarter. There's the front position there for King for Casey. Talk about famous names. In the teams, Todd Vanderhaar, number 8 for the Casey Demons today. Famous name.
Good to see, yep.
We had plenty of them last week at Victoria Park in Collingwood and the Northern Blues as we wait for this ball to be tossed back in again. It's right near the boundary line. And just thumped back forward. Trying to get there is Kerridge. He can't keep it in. We'll do it again. They'll have another go at trying to get this ball into play and try and get something going. Players get into position. Ruckman nominates. King going to work. Phillips there as well. King trying to get the front position, went over his head. Phillips was there through the hands of Wilson for the Blues, but there's Trengove trying to kick as far as possible. Did a reasonable job of it, but it's going to be turned over. Sheehan, pretty good last week in the win over Collingwood. Working across to McCready, looks like in the side today. And he's spotted up a nice target as we wait for the ball to come inside the 50 from Carey. Just going to be turned over again and getting into good position, Liam Hewlett, and Casey away on the outer side.
So Stretch hemmed in against the boundary line, well played by Jackson. Little handball over the top was okay. Moncrief looped it over the top, wanting a run here, and he got it from Neil Bullen, who went further afield to Harms. One way then the other, in a little bit of trouble, had to get around his man, and he did nicely before he turned over with the kick. And it's nicely taken by Boakhurst. He squares them off. Wilson running across half back. He's come to our commentary side of the ground. And Liam takes the mark at half back. Nice crowd in here this afternoon. Still a bit of room in the grandstand, but plenty of eyes on this one as Mark has taken a short ball from Armfield, who retreats 35 metres to find a position of Jones at centre half back. Another short kick is neat, and McCready takes this one. So Harrison McCready heads to the outer side, looking for a contest here. One-on-one knocked away from Jax by Moncrief at ground level. Who's going to pick it up first? Kennedy Harris, happy to see it over, and they'll toss it in. Outer side of the ground, just repeating that news. If you've just joined us, Angus Brayshaw taken off the ground in the first 30 seconds of the match with what we think is a concussion. We'll bring you the latest as it comes to hand. Glen Hill with all the news boundary side. Here's Phillips at the contest looking for Harms. He doesn't mind that scrap in tight, and he tosses it back to the umpire and says, you have a go. So do I.
All right. Let's see. He won 1-7, playing no score. This opening quarter. Ball tossed back up. Wilson trying to work his way around, just worried off the footy by Neil Bullen. Eventually spills free. Trying to get into a good position is Keppel, 23rd player again today for the Blues. And just working it out nicely on this side of the ground. This one into the path of Wilson. He can't pick it up. He gives a thumbs up to his teammate further up the field. Jordan Moncrief there too for the Demons, and we'll have it thrown in.
Quickly around the grounds, Freo by 10 points against, Freo by 11 points, I should say, against the Tigers. 24 gone, second term.
So just confirming, Harrison McCready is in the team today for the Blues, despite what we said as Kerridge 360. Still managed to get the ball away, trying to get into position as Billy Stretch at the bottom of the pack. It's going nowhere, and the umpire will throw the ball up. Tossed up again, and the umpire's gone down behind play. Gallucci ridden into the turf, going nowhere. Neil Bullen laying the tackle. We'll have it thrown up. 1-1-7, no score. Blues leading. Phillips hacks it towards the boundary line into the path of Boakhurst, who's had a good couple of weeks. His kick is short and good. A nice mark taken by Gorringe. Tight on the boundary line here. He'll be kicking from just inside the 50. On that outer side, he's looking around at some options. Phillips just dragging himself to the goal square. So is Jax. He comes in here. Daniel Gorringe puts it up high. It's not going to make the distance. Phillips, one grab, not the second. Couldn't take it. Now an opportunity here into the path of Scott for the Casey side. He goes by hand over the top. It's dangerous. It's almost out of play. It hasn't gone out of play, actually. Kennedy kept it in. I think he was a little bit surprised. Got off to Trengove. Now the short kick's been touched. Sheen went past him. Here's Dennis. Handball across to Wilson. To Keppel, who's going outside of the boot. He's found a player in space. That's nicely done. Oh, they worked that out well, the Blues. And Kerridge takes it. And he'll line up and have a shot directly in front from just inside the 50. Got plenty of it, Sam Kerridge there. Hilly?
Yes. With there being no breeze today, I think Sam Kerridge should be able to kick the distance from there. He is only probably a 50 to 55 metre kick at best. So he'll be kicking just on 50.
So in he comes. Sam Kerridge steps inside the 50, kicks from 49. Got the distance, not the accuracy though. Another behind. 1-1-8, low scoring game early on. Playing Casey, no score as we've crossed 10 minutes of this opening quarter. Peter Jackson, VFL live today, and it's great to see the manual scoreboard in operation too.
So Casey to bring it out, long ball, hoping for Harms to fly. Kelty's at the back too, knocked away from the contest in the air at ground level. Little sidestep there from Hillard. Lost the handle on it though in the handball, was chopped off. That was nicely done by Paulson. Got it across to his teammate there in Keppel. He headed across the ground, big ball to be won as the Blues who come up with it. They've looked a good so far. A long ball inside the 50 now at the back. Sumner's got the sit and he takes the mark. Good use going in from Beaukhurst. Didn't waste any time. Drove it all the way to the line. And Sumner will kick from 5 metres out directly in front.
That deep ball's really really hurting Casey at the moment. The Carlton, the Northern Blues forward certainly look tall and ominous up.
So Sumner, just the one goal from his two games so far this year. In game number three, for goal number two, shouldn't have any issues and doesn't. That's the Blues' second of the afternoon. They're 1-2-14 as we take into the 2-2-14. Gee, last week we had the most dynamic scoreboard operation in the history of the game at Williamstown, Pete. I'll fill you in on that at quarter time. It'll make you pleased. 14 is the score, 2-2. 11 minutes gone, opening term. And Hilly, Pete, the Blues.
I'm intrigued by this scoreboard now.
Well, I'll get down to Hilly, get his thoughts on it. But at the moment, this game looks all the Blues early.
They're certainly controlling the play at the moment. They've got a great structure running through the midfield. And Casey certainly need to start winning the stoppages, or they're going to be in a lot of trouble here.
So we return to the middle. In the ruck now, Cunningham for the North. In fact, it's Korchek for the Blues. What am I saying is the ball on the deck is Kenny Harris got to pick himself up. The international rookie, Matthew Korchek. Ball tossed up, goes back again to work with King. Ball down to Wilson. He's tackled by Gent, going nowhere, and the umpire will throw it up. Paulson just skirting the pack.
Matthew Korchek listed at 208 centimetres, Pete.
He is a tall fellow. As the ball here through hands, and there's going to be an too high the call from the umpire in the middle of the ground. It's going to be Casey free kick. It's going the way of Neil Bullen. He gets around Gallucci, kicks up towards the 50. Big fly again there from Sheehan. He couldn't bring it down. Players diving in on top of the pack. And the umpire will throw it up on 50 for Casey. Want to just get something to get him going in this opening quarter. Tossed up as Korchek from over the top. Still Casey looking to press forward here. Dangerous position for the Blues. McCready lost a handle on it. Kennedy Harris just pushing it towards the line. Bouncing footy will land right on the goal line. It's going to be kept in though by the Blues. Kerry, it might be a dangerous option, but they're going to get out of it okay. The long ball working there was King. Went straight over his head. Jones picked it up. He's immediately tackled and the umpire will come in and throw the ball up. So half forward for Casey on the grandstand side, 2-2-14, plays no score. Ball tapped down, Korchek, but only as far as Neil Bullen, who puts it inside 50, and Jones takes the relieving mark for the Blues.
He's got it about 40 out, 45 degree angle defensively, and he brings it to our commentary side. That's a nice lead from Kerr, who takes the mark and then dishes off quickly. Beaukhurst giving them a bit off half back. This is a dangerous ball, but a beautiful kick that lands in the arms of Wilson. Now some space on the outer side. Gent goes to close down McCready but can't. He gets the kick away over the top and he's found his man Sumner. Now Ferreira's just got to be a bit careful. He didn't give the 50 away. Sumner's off. He around the corner he goes over the head of the target. Now who can pick it up low to the ground? It's near the line. It's over the line. And they'll toss it in. Harms happy to see that Gallucci, the man chasing, and we'll have a ball in literally on the point post. At the City end. So 2-2-14, the Blues to Casey, yet to score. Good transition of the footy there. Sees them in the forward pocket. Chance now as they go forward. Paulson might have been taken without the footy. Kilty just banged it high and hard to get it out of trouble, but Pickett's there to take the mark for the Blues. And they're well set up. We've seen this throughout their start to the year. Look like they're functioning pretty well. High ball now to 20 metres out. Who's going to fly? One at the back. A little early on the train. Got the wrong timetable. So the Blues still a chance. A left foot kick retreats, and that'll do.
It was Jack Hutchins who flew for that ball.
So Gorringe comes back in board, and he finds Russell. in the fluoro yellow boots this afternoon. Comes back to Jones. They're going to try and open Casey up via the cape. Now a little ball back through the middle. Comes to Pickett. That was from Buckley. And now what's going on down the ground?
Blood rule.
So we'll have a stop in play. And it's a significant blood rule too. Looks like Hillard's coming off. Some cut across that left eyebrow. Might need a new top by the look of it too.
Yep, Brenton Hillard.
Chance now for Pickett to go. Oh, he's almost caught from behind. He got it away just in the nick of time. Long ball. There's 3-on-1 in the marking contest. There's a push, and it's going to go the way of...
Casey. Yeah, it's a Casey free kick.
3-on-1 there, and Phillips just felt the pinch a little. So the kick to be brought out by Declan Kelty.
Good player, Declan Kelty. For the Demons, his kick going up the line. Jones coming in from the side. Fritsch for the Demons. Picking up there, Jones trying to work it out. He's lost a handle on it. Good tackling pressure. That's Baker laying the tackle. Number 31 for the Demons. And we'll have it thrown up. Just forward of centre here for the Blues. Lead it by 14 points. 14 plays nothing. Midway through this opening quarter on Peter Jackson VFL Live. Quickly out of the pack there by Kilty. Just threw it onto the boot, turned it over, and found Jones. There's Jones up the line to Dennis. Needs no surname, just operates as Dennis. Got a station named after him. Oh, that kick, not very Dennis-like, and it's got out of bounds. We'll have it thrown in. Injury updates, blood rule update. Brenton Hillard, Hilly.
Yes, he suffered a severe little lash just above the eyebrow, so that's getting attended to at the moment, but I'm sure that'll be able to be sewn up and be back on the track soon.
Any word on Angus Brayshaw? Is he still in the rooms?
He's just come out of the rooms, so
for
some air, by the look of things.
Okay, well, we'll keep a close eye on that. As Kennedy Harris had his pocket picked, here's an opportunity. Sumner, short little ball is good. And the Blues are starting to build something really nice here. Early stages, but the signs are all good. They're just controlling the footy.
Yeah, they're making it hard to exit, aren't they?
And considering all the time it's spent inside the 50, as we see this kick coming in for a behind. Another miss. You really think they should be a little bit further in front. They've had plenty of the footy. And one behind the results from Kerr as we wait for this ball to come back in. It's a long, high ball coming out. Korchek from position. And he's got it. Nicely done in the end. Good pack mark. And he's 55 from goal. He's just going to throw it on the boot as high as he possibly can. One for the Flyers. No one could take it. At ground level, ball on the deck, trying to get it out is Hewlett. He's at the bottom of the pack for the Demons, and we'll have it thrown up deep into attack here for the Blues. 2-3-15, plays no score. Home side leading.
Yeah, going to be hard for Casey to get it out, even if they get position again. Gents in there trying to do exactly that. Came out, squeezed, kick, but it was touched, so Shin's mark won't stand. Came to ground. Who's going to pick it up? Ferreira. Oh, beautifully tackled by Pickett. Didn't give the free kick away. Great contest, both players. And neither of them had any issue just getting up and getting to the next contest. So Phillips against Kilty here, out the back. Nicely picked up by Vanderhaar. Got Ferreira into a little bit of trouble. Gent has to throw it onto the boot. Kennedy flies for Casey. Out the back now. Stretch, quick little handball. Trouble now. Good pressure there from Keppel as he knocked it to ground. Casey Demons are going to come away with it here. Scott got it away. Down the line they go, but only momentarily as again Sheehan was well set up and the Blues are on again. Little thought of a handball over the top. Ignored. That was by Sumner. Beautiful kick now for Kerr, who has it directly in front, 50 from home. They're an organised unit just at the moment, the Blues.
I think that's a good way to describe it.
Hard for Casey to get through anywhere. Not through lack of intensity, just through a well-set-up ground. Kerr, beautiful chip, and that won't please Justin Plapp at all. An unmarked man, 45 out, takes the mark. and that man is Jed Lamb. So he'll kick from a slight angle, 52 out. What do you reckon, Hilly? Can he get the distance?
I think he can. He's a really good kick of the footy, so I'll be backing him in here for distance.
It'll be his first major of the year if he can carry it through to the city end. An opening term, 15 to zip before the kick as we hit time on. This is starting left, got the distance easily but missed convincingly left. So 2-4-16 the Blues, Casey yet to score.
So it's James Harms to bring the ball back in for Casey. Kicks to himself, and then gets out of a little bit of trouble. And just goes straight up the middle, Neil Bullen. Still inside defensive 50, deciding to go to the outer side of the ground, and that's okay as they build again on this outer side. The Demons, nope, the switch is on. It's going to come all the way back, and Hewlett is there. Let's see if they can switch to the grandstand side. Nope, we're just going to go straight back again, Hewlett. And Armfield goes to him. The kick going straight up the line is not bad. Oh, but that kick's terrible. Vanderhaar. He marked it okay and then wanted to go on with it. A little casual with his kick. It's smothered over the line. We'll have it thrown in.
Yeah, first bit was good, wasn't it? Just probably a little bit unlucky. Phillips is one of the bigger men on the ground.
Brenton Hillard's just emerged from the rooms and he'll be back on the ground soon wearing the mummy wrap, and he'll be in the number four.
Okay. As we see here, Wilson on the end of a chain of handballs. It's a high ball going inside the 50, but Moncrief relieving Mark for the Demons. He goes outside the 50, dangerous. Ferreira had a bit of work to do and he's still not out of trouble. Jack's got the handball away to O'Shea, and we will have it thrown in. And a little bit of push and shove out there as well. Nothing much in that. As O'Shea picks up his mouth guard. Probably would want to wash that down since it hit the turf, but no, just whacked it straight in the mouth. So we see 55 from goal. The ball to be thrown in. Blues in attack, as they have been for most of this quarter. And it's just bobbling in front of him. It was Harms going around the body. You hear it just clattering into the advertising hoardings on the other side of the ground. We'll have it thrown in. Just forward of centre for the Blues. 2-3-15 plays, no score. As we're making our way inside time on, 22 minutes gone in this quarter. Now, big kick from Russell, going long and high all the way to the pocket. Jack's got hands to it. Kerr trying to keep it in. He handballs over the top. No, it's going to be thrown in. The field umpire and boundary umpire working together there. And it was the field umpire who made the call. Was in a really good position to see that. And we'll have the ball thrown in. Still in attack here for the Blues. As we heard from Glenn Hill, pre-game, no breeze really to speak of as Phillips getting the tap down off the ground into the goal square. Hewlett with a bit of work to do. Goes by hand over the top. That's okay. As they look to clear, this is Harms going deep outside the 50. He's turned the footy over again. And really, this is where they're struggling across half back. The Casey side at the moment. They might get another opportunity. Kenny Harris lays the handball off. Now it's a foot race. It's one-on-one, the foot race. The ball needs to bounce nicely. It does in the end. Casey looked to get the handball across. It was Scott. He's going to get the ball back again. Needs to pull his shorts up. Play it down. I think it's Bokers behind play. Handball across to Tringove. Tringove goes across the 50. And nicely done. It's Alessio Ferreira who's taken the mark, who should just go back and have a shot. He'll kick from 47 metres out, pretty much directly in front, and a chance at the first score for the Demons as we've played almost 25 minutes in this opening term.
Yeah, fair to say they need this one, Pete. Although it could be worse on the scoreboard.
So Ferreira comes in. Left shoe misses. First score on the board. There, one behind. Northern Blues 2-3-15 deep into this opening quarter.
Just got another injury update. Blaine Bokers just limped off the ground and it's being attended to. Seems to have a lower leg injury at the moment.
That's not good news for the Blues because he's been an exceptional player. As we see, handball over the top. trying to get into space is Dwyer. He's dragged into the turf, and the umpire will come in and intervene. You see Hillard in picture there, just getting out of the way, wearing the number 4 for Casey. I'd love to get a score on the board before quarter time.
Nice stuff from Kerridge. Release the handball out the back. The kick down the line will suit a 50-50 ball, and the boundary umpire to come in and throw it in. So Gorringe, happy to see that one over. Everything going, I think, the way Josh Fraser would like. The only thing he would have perhaps enjoyed is one or two cleaner finishes with the ball at the 50-metre arc. But other than that, going beautifully. Ferreira gets it here from Harms. Kick down, looking for Kennedy Harris. Here's Cunningham. Well tackled. Ball spilled free. Too high, said the umpire, and will come back.
Half time at the MCG. Freo by 5. 5-6, 36 to 5-1, 31. I'll get your score from Box Hill in a moment as well.
So Cunningham has the footy in the middle of the ground. He'll come to our commentary site looking for and finding his man, Jared Pickett, who started this game nicely, opening term. Eyes darting left, and then he heads to the right forward pocket. Wants a mark in the air. Phillips couldn't quite get to the contest. Good stuff from King and Moncrief to work him out of it as Vanderhaar sees that one over. So they'll toss it in, 5 metres around from the point post.
Just on Jared Pickett, Leeds, he's certainly looking a bit more influential when he's behind the ball rather than playing deep forward.
Yeah, he's been given a nice role here this afternoon, playing it to a plum as it comes out the back. Little slick in the end for Neil Bullen, coming through there. Hillard, who's well tackled, and that's Gallucci doing the work there for the Blues in the forward pocket. They'll toss it up.
We should mention David Cunningham wearing number 16 today for the Northern Blues, a last second change. Wonder what the VFL will have to say about that.
Here's Hillard as his handball's stolen but won't go far as the ball's taken over. Kerridge there.
Three-quarter time, Box Hill 12-6-78, leading Richmond 10-14-74. Hawks were 29 points down early in the third quarter there.
So Dwyer doing a good job on Kerridge. They're not giving him much space as this one's tossed back in. Phillips front position, knocked out the back but couldn't find a player initially. Harms tries to bust a line but he can't. Well tackled, got the handball away, said the umpire. Again, some good tackling. Dwyer got it out the back, under pressure now. For King, drives a high ball, big flight to back, Jones. Nice stuff from Liam. He wants to go quickly and does. Heads to the pocket. There's a one-on-one. Are they going to get company? No. Knocked to ground. Gallucci's there. Couldn't take it cleanly. Out the back, Vanderhaar. Well played. Got the handball away. Trouble for Neil Bullen. Good enough to get it away. And then Moncrief was under all sorts of pressure from Paulson. And they'll toss it in where the arc meets the boundary line.
There's a push and shove going on inside 50. I don't think Kerr liked the attention he received from that initial contest.
27 gone opening term, 15 points to margin, the Blues in front.
Ball to be tossed back in. And on inside the 50 now for the Blues. Going to the top, Phillips. Going to ride some bumps here as Wilson. He was taken high, he's going to get a free kick. So free kick for Wilson. James Munro, a little bit crude there. And the skipper should go back and have a shot. There's Matty Korchek comes back out onto the ground. Also Jared Pickett for the final stages of this opening term. It's Tom Wilson, the captain of the Blues. On the siren. The margin stands at 15 points. Comes in now, the kick looks good. Looks very good. Blues fans are happy because it's been their quarter. And at quarter time, they've got three on the board. They're 3-4-22, the Blues. The Casey Demons are one behind. And all of the Blues players get into a huddle. They're backslapping. They're getting behind the captain, which is probably a smart team move, I would have thought. Well, for Casey, they've got a bit of work to do. It was all the Blues in that quarter. The goal kickers to quarter time, all singles. Wilson, as we saw there, Jax and Sumner, and no goals on the board yet for the Demons, just the one behind. Repeating the big news from earlier today, about a minute or inside the opening minute of the game, Angus Brayshaw copped a heavy knock, was taken from the ground, suffering what we think is concussion. He's made his way back out onto the bench, Hilly. Was he out there for the rest of the quarter? He's gone back into the room.
No, he only just made a very brief appearance, I think, just to get air, to be quite honest. And he's currently undergoing the protocol testing.
All right, well, we'll get an update from you on the other side of the break to see how he's going there. But in the meantime, it's quarter time here. It's 3-4-22, the Blues, the Demons, one behind. Back with the second quarter action next on Peter Jackson VFL Live.
I'm a digital radio. To help explain why it's time to update your old radio, with me is my friend Digital TV.
Hi.
Where you go?
Remember when us TVs went digital?
Everyone does. Get to the point.
Suddenly, you got lots more channels for free.
Yes.
Well, it's the same with digital radio.
When you buy a digital radio, you can get all your favourite stations, plus up to 30 extra ones, playing all kinds of music, live, sport and talk.
That's pretty great.
It's really great.
All you have to do is head into your nearest retailer.
Or check out digitalradioplus.com.au.
And upgrade to digital.
Last year, Vision Australia helped more than 33,000 people who are blind or have low vision. So if you find that glasses are no longer helping and you're struggling to complete daily tasks, why not give us a call? Our free services, provided by specialist staff, can help increase your independence. We also offer advice on equipment and provide training in how to travel around safely with limited vision. Vision can help you make a real difference. Call us now, 1-300-847-466.
Love your sport? Then you'll love SEN.
1-2, Jamie Wink up first. Craig Lowndes second.
And you'll find it on digital radio. Simply scroll to SEN, Melbourne's home of sport.
The Red Time Sport iPhone app is here and ready to download. The app allows you to listen to the different sports BPM media broadcasts wherever you are in the world, including VFL and TAC Cup radio and a whole lot more. You can interact with the commentary team in real time via the Red Time Sport iPhone app feedback and social networking buttons. Plus, check out upcoming broadcasts. Catch up with the latest sports headlines from around the world via the Sports News button. The Red Time Sport iPhone app. Download it from the iTunes Store today. Visit bpmmedia.com.au for more details.
I'm a digital radio.
And I'm a digital TV. Now, you may remember when TV went digital.
Yes, yes, and you got a lot more channels and a better picture.
Well, buying a digital radio is the same.
Exactly. I've got up to 30 extra radio stations, plus all your old faves, and I sound amazing.
Yeah, but I look amazing.
Yeah, but this is a radio ad, so no one can see you.
Oh, yeah.
So if you want to hear this station like you have never heard it before,
buy a digital radio.
Head into your nearest retailer and upgrade to digital.
Next week, Peter Jackson VFL Live is at Burbank Oval for the Round 6 clash between Williamstown and Richmond. That's next Sunday afternoon from 1:45, live on the Red Time Sport iPhone app and audio and video stream through vfl.com.au.
On Aussie Digital, streaming live through vfl.com.au and on the Red Time Sport iPhone app, this is Peter Jackson VFL Live.
Well, it is quarter time and it is a 21-point lead to the Northern Blues, 3-4-22 to the Casey Demons, one behind. Teams in their huddles. I'm going to hear from Blues coach Josh Fraser out of the quarter time huddle with Hilly, but let's go around the grounds while we have the opportunity. And at the MCG, interesting game unfolding there. But let's bring you up to date with the Peter Jackson VFL matches. And it's quarter time up at Coburg. And it's 3-3-21 Coburg, leading Sandringham 2-2-14. And so that is a quarter time score from up there. And here 3-4-22 playing one behind. We'll bring you a score update from Box Hill as well. 21 minutes into the final quarter, and it's 16-6-102 Box Hill, leading Richmond 12-16-88. So it looks like Box Hill are going to get the win there, you would think.
It's a big turnaround.
And in the other game,
it was 18 points at halftime, that one, Pete.
Back the way of
Richmond. Richmond were in front by 18 points, and in fact Box Hill kicked the last two goals of the second quarter to get them within 18 points. So,
and it's half time at the MCG, 5-6-36. In fact, no, they're into the third quarter. 2 minutes into the third quarter, 5-7-37 Frio, lead by a goal to Richmond, 5-1-31. So you're up to date with all the scores at the moment. The other games coming up, the game in China today between Box Hill and Port Adelaide. But Hilly is scouting around the packs. Josh Fraser.
Thanks, Pete. Joined by Josh Fraser. Another positive start, mate.
I thought our pressure was terrific, probably as good as we've done all year. Our boys have bought into that part of the game really well, so that's given us a chance to win a bit of the ball and move it the way we want to.
You mentioned just then at quarter time that you'd like the boys to be a little cleaner going forward.
Yeah, we've had opportunities inside 50. over, but just there's been some other occasions where we've been a little bit untidy going inside 50 as well. So there's some growth in our game still.
And also too, just your pressure around the ball was fantastic in the first quarter.
Yeah, it was. It's been a focus for us all year, and it's an area of our game we think that we build off. And yeah, again, the boys, the midfielders, the small forwards, they've all delivered on it really well.
No worries. Thanks, Josh, for your time.
Beautifully done. Thank you, Hilly. There with Josh Fraser, and he would be happy with the pressure and the intensity here, because I'll tell you, if we had the stats breakdown, I'd say in terms of time inside forward half, it would be all one-way traffic, because very rarely, I think maybe only a handful of times we saw Casey go inside the 50.
Yeah, and just on Casey, just reading off their Twitter account, they will try and update Casey and Melbourne fans as soon as they know more. Unfortunately, no update on the fact that he's gone off.
Angus Brayshaw, the player we're talking about here. Hilly, any more news from down there on Angus Brayshaw?
He's certainly undergoing the concussion protocol testing now as we speak, and hopefully we'll get some sort of result before halftime.
I suspect, just looking at it from a long way away, that test or not, they probably want to err on the side of caution, you would think. A player like Angus Brayshaw, who's unfortunately had a good run at it of late.
Yeah, if you're a Melbourne, a Casey, or a football fan, you would have known the troubles that he's had. Just to let you know, he wasn't out cold when he went to ground, so it wasn't a bad hit, but it was a strong hit, the sort of hit you cop in the early in the game where everyone's pumped up about getting to the first contest. It didn't look like it was all head, but he was in trouble straight away, and the trainers looked after him beautifully as they took him off. So we wish him and his family all the best. Never good to see.
So it's Kilty and Phillips in the ruck to start off this second quarter. A 21-point lead to the Northern Blues. 3-4, 22, playing one behind. Let's see what Casey can do in this second term.
Yeah, got some questions to answer to the Demons. Magnificent win last night against Adelaide for the senior side in Melbourne. And here in the VFL, they're battling hard against the Blues, and straight away Neil Bullen comes away from the middle. High ball, top of the square, not going to get a mark from King. Ball at ground level, Scott's in terrific touch this year. He's going to swing it across the body, too far across the body, bouncing towards the line. Harms was there, but he couldn't stop it going over the line as Bokhurst is back on the ground after suffering what looked to be an ankle injury early in that, well, I should say late in that first quarter. And we're ready to toss it in. What can Casey get going? Kennedy's amongst it, as is Scott. Harms, no surprise there at the bottom of the pack. Phillips, Kennedy, Harris, still no clean possession. Now, the umpire's found one here. It's going to go the way of the Blues, and they can get themselves out of trouble.
Mitch Harms staying down that side of the ground, swung from defence up into attack. Is this ball heading long in the carriage direction? With this coming from Billy Stretch, as the ball near the line, taken over there, Neil Bullen. He's being held up, and the umpire will throw it up right near the boundary line on the grandstand side of the ground, just into attack here for Casey. We've got a bit of work to do. Kilty and Phillips. Phillips getting it down. Neil Bullen again, just hurling it onto the boot, putting it inside the 50. Now, this is a big opportunity for Kennedy. Harris was brought down the tackle, but got the kick away, and he put it through. And a badly needed goal. Jay Kennedy Harris gets the first on the board for the Demons. They're 1-1-7, playing the Northern Blues 3-4-22. Early stages, second quarter here on Peter Jackson, VFL Live.
Sam Kerridge looked to cop a knock either on his foot or ankle. And just his little proppy at the moment. He's staying out there. I'll keep an eye on it.
Yeah, just seeing him, he's now going into a slow jog to get back into position to match up against Billy Stretch, but yeah, we'll see how he goes. He certainly had the physio out there and said, no, don't need anything, I'm just going to run this off. So let's see what happens.
So Russell got to eye for company in the middle, out the back of that contest. It's the goal kicker, Kennedy Harris, who sends him inside the 50 again. A chance for Kennedy if he can hang on. He does. Got the handball away just in the nick of time. Now almost a broken tackle. Good stuff from Dwyer. Left foot to the top of the square. It's going to beat them all and go through, is it? Oh, it's a cruel game. And it's a shocking shape ball for all concerned at times. 22-8, 3 minutes gone, second term. The Blues to bring it back in.
Oh, yes, right into the base of the post. There's a kick going long. Working here, Phillips. He had to do the punching work. Moncrief, they're going to hit inside 50 again here. But a good defensive mark from O'Shea, the Blues. Stops another Casey attack. Going to Bokhurst, who's going outside the 50 for Sumner. Takes the mark. At halfback. Wants to go inboard. Looking for O'Shea. Dangerous. Coming in Fritsch to create the contest. Hand did well. Got some numbers here. The Demons is the kick from Tringove. Oh, it's hit the post too. Couple in a row.
They've certainly lifted their intensity to start this quarter, Pete.
So 1-3-9, plays 3-4-22. They certainly have lifted, but all the scoring to the right of screen. As we see the ball here for the Blues, Jack's trying to get into good position, dropped what he should have taken, now ran into the tackle. Still managed to get the handball away. Kerridge working with Armfield. Back to Kerridge. Handball across Gallucci. Didn't find him in the end. Here's Munro putting the handball, trying to find some space. It ends up with Stretch, who did really well. Goes for a run. Kicks deep into the pocket. Well, they come from all directions in the end. The boundary line wins out. Mitch King trying to go backwards. Almost take that one-handed. Still deep into attack here for the Casey Demons. As we see... Was a free kick?
Yeah, against Kennedy Harris for crashing into the back of Pickett, I think.
So it's Paulson who's got it. Who kicks up, looking for King, couldn't find him. Kerridge tackled by Stretch, and the umpire will come in and throw the ball up. Again, bit of push and shove going on. Korchek just getting in to help his teammate. He's so tall, he could almost just pick him up and put him back on his feet. Almost crane-like as... Get the tap down that time, but only as far as Harms inside the 50. No one can take the mark as eventually spills free, working it around the body is Johnston. He goes right into the teeth of goal. Dangerous. O'Shea held up in the tackle, released it to the line. We'll have it thrown in. Angus Scott lurking.
He had a magnificent handball on the halfback flank here to release a teammate. He's in terrific touch and being considered for Victorian representative duties as King comes over the top here. Free kick, whistle on play, going to go the way of the Blues. Yep. In the back at the ruck contest, and it'll be Korchek who got it away to Bokhurst, to Buckley. Back pocket, wants to go long for the Blues. Get it out of trouble. Jax has got the sit, but he had three to beat. No whistle on play, so Moncrief can mop up at the back for the Demons. Handball inboard to Kelty. Got the handball away in the nick of time. Neil Bullen held onto it nicely, then gave it to Dwyer. Across to Harms, runs to 49. Shocking kick. Didn't get any of it. Might land for Kennedy. Harris to Kennedy, whichever one you want. Through the hands of Buckley. Right on the line, a chance now, is it there? No.
Fritsch.
They made very hard work of all of that, and in the end, they just got a behind. 1-4-10, trails 3-4-22, as Pete mentioned, Bailey Fritsch, the man, to get it across the line in the end.
Buckley to O'Shea, to Kerridge. Still inside defensive 50, the Blues. Amazing, on a still day, all the scoring is still to one end. Oh, that's not a great kick. Bokhurst did okay. Back to Buckley. He gets himself out of trouble. And that's not a bad kick to Armfield, who goes a bit further afield. They're working it out nicely. Cunningham wearing the 16 today instead of the 60. To Kerr, to Korchek. Gets on the end of this. 55 from goal. Looking for some options. LeBois, one of those, potentially. No, he's got the player driving by. Now the kick inside the 50 is Armfield. Little double grabber, and Dennis has got it. But he'll be kicking from outside the 50, but on a still day, he shouldn't have too many problems here. In terms of distance, it'll be accuracy that'll be the key. Korchek just working his way down to the goal line. As we see, Dennis Armfield, such an experienced player for both Carlton and the Northern Blues. Steps to the 50 now, gives it absolutely everything. Wow, thought he might have had a chance at the distance. It stopped just before the goal line. Jack's trying to take the mark, couldn't do so. So 3-5-23, playing 1-4-10 in this second quarter. We've played 6 minutes.
So Harms to himself, being asked to do a lot of work out there. He tries to take his man on and did, second time. Got away with it just. No, he's run too far. Well, you couldn't question the attitude, but in the end, he just couldn't get past.
He's got to be careful here. He might give a 50 away.
Yes, and in the end, it was the measuring tape that got him, not a tackler. I thought at one stage, Hilly, he might have been tripped. But the umpire said perhaps the meterage game was too far before that happened, and Gallucci is going to be the man to take the kick. So Gallucci, five in from the boundary line. He'll have to cover 38 with the kick. Tries to get some more angle and then swings it across his body and misses to the left-hand side. 3-6, 24 in front of KC, 1-4-10. We've gone 8 minutes in this second
turn. Oh, having all sorts of trouble getting this ball out of defence. He's at the 50 now, and Fritsch takes the mark. Handball over the top looking for Gent. Back playing for this KC Demons line up to Tringove. The kick up the line, no good. It's going to be turned over. Keppel takes it. Now he's got inboard options, one of those O'Shea. Takes it edge of the square, centre wing. And just going to go back again. So a little bit of kick-to-kick sort of stuff going on. As Keppel kicks up the line, needs a high fly, gets a high flyer, it's Jones again. Loves getting airborne. He's kicked, looking for Phillips, falls over the back. Kerr's got some time. Little handball over the top. Dangerous! Maybe a push in the back for Dubois. And the umpire says, yeah, it's a push in the back. It'll be a free kick.
Just from my angle, Pete, looked like he's pushing the back by two players.
Yeah, we did see definite hands in the back there. I don't think they could really argue the toss. Kim Lebois to have the shot at goal on the boundary line. He's going to go around. Called to play on. Low ball goal. Great kick. Lebois with his first. 4-6-30, playing 1-4-10 here on Peter Jackson VFL Live. And well, that just stems the tide a little bit because it was all the Demons in the opening 8 or so minutes of the quarter. They go down the other end, the Blues, and they get the result. And good defensive pressure from the Blues forwards there.
Yeah, they've made it difficult all day, really, haven't they? I mean, whether it's been coming out from a kick-in or a passage of play where once they've got that ball inside their forward 50, I mean, very hard to get out from. And looks like Thomas Baker's coming back onto the ground here for Kings. We'll keep an eye on that one for you. This bounce is going to be recalled in the middle. And it will be Kelty and Korchek.
Final score. Box Hill remaining undefeated. 18-8, 116 to Richmond, 13-6, 94.
So this ball still to be worked on in the middle. And the last goal kicker at the bottom of this pack. Players will come in, and Tommy Wilson amongst that. Munro's got his man.
Boys, unfortunately I can confirm that Angus Brayshaw won't be rejoining the play today.
Yeah, just joined us. Angus suffered a big hit early in the game and was taken from the field immediately. So we wish him all the best in his recovery. Another stoppage here. Kennedy Harris just flicked it out the back. Wanted to run. I didn't get one. Gallucci was there. Sheehan in support. He bangs towards the outer wing. Coming to meet the footy there. Kerr in front of his man Hillard. Did well. Got it away to Wilson. Goes inside the 50. Wants a mark. 1-2. Will that do? There's a whistle. It'll be one or the other. It's going to be a free kick to the Demons. Heading to the outer side. Half back flank. Dodgy ball. Bouncing ball for Tringove. Good enough to get it to Neil Bullen. But the pressure's closing for the Northern Blues everywhere. Wilson got it away quickly. Left foot kick around the corner to centre half forward. Kennedy. In fact, it is Kennedy Harris who takes the mark. He's looking for Munro at half back. Handball over the top for Stretch. Bokehurst closes the space. He's forced around the corner with a kick. Gets it down the line now. Can McCready keep it in? He can't. It's out. Munro just... there's a little to do as the ball goes over the line. Little contact, nothing wrong with that, Hilly. They'll toss it in right in front of you. Scores 30-10, 16 gone, second turn.
All fair in love and war, Leedy.
Well, yes, because right near the interchange benches, there are a lot of players milling around there. Ball to the back, it's King. Their first, second, third, fourth efforts. Had all of them in the end from that ruck contest. Going to do it himself as the Demons look to press forward. Fritsch, good mark.
Good hand.
Was dealt with by Keppel. So wants to go on with it, putting the ball towards the 50, and a good mark again. Relieving mark for the Blues. And that's McCready again, who's looking to go to the outer side. Find some players in space. One of those is Kerridge. Takes the mark, goes up the line, and the switch will be back on again. So that's not a good option going up the line of the outer side. So Pickett will switch Keppel. Now they break as the short option, decides to go longer, but that's into no one in particular, and Stretch comes in to take the mark, sets it up towards centre half forward. It's going to be turned over again. Cunningham working the ball back to O'Shea, who kicks to a player in all sorts of space. This is Jax, who looks ahead, needs some players to run for him, finds Jed Lamb, who takes the mark 52 metres from goal, looking for Korchek. No, Kerridge the better option. And while he's lining up, assuming he doesn't give it off, it's a handy advantage to Freo midway through the third quarter, Leedsy.
Yeah, 25 points to margin, 18 gone in the third term, 8-9-57 to 5-2-32.
So the margin at the moment at 20 points. Dennis Armfield runs back out onto the ground. And so Sam Kerridge steps inside the 50, directly in front, and he's missed. 4-7-31, plays 1-4-10, as we've played 14 minutes in this second quarter on Peter Jackson VFL Live. Next week, Williamstown, Richmond, our game for broadcast next Sunday.
Now looking for a target, Hewlett, dodgy ball in, asked his teammate to supply all sorts of courage, and he did. Neil Bullen was there, got it to Vanderhaar and then got it from him. His kick was smothered. Sumner's the man for the Blues, tracking the footy towards the line. He finds O'Shea. O'Shea, little ball inside the 50. It bounces okay. Who's going to be first to it at ground level? Vanderhaar got the handball away. Well, Ferreira through traffic, looking for support. Cunningham laid a tackle, and it's going to be too high. And the kick will go to Casey, Sean Dwyer, and goes down the line, and a big grab on the wing. Magnificent stuff from Fritsch, who wanted to play on quickly. What was he thinking? He should have just soaked it up a little. Now the ball quickly on the for the Blues as Cunningham takes the mark, and he stops and props and comes back inboard. Polson's taken it. He's got options on our side of the ground. Here's Wilson, takes it at centre half forward. He's not going to go to Armfield. He's going to go further backwards. Long ball from Pickett. No, he just measures the kick. Kerr got a knee in. Took the man, but not the ball. Out the back, a chance for Buckley. 52 from home. His kick smothered. Now the Casey side under all sorts of pressure inside the 50. Hewlett comes out. He's well tackled. Good stuff, Jax. What's the umpire going to say? No prior opportunity. Give it to me. I'll toss it up, but let's get back to the hang from Fritsch, silly.
Oh, it was huge. I'm at ground level, and he had some serious hang time there.
Just something to lift him, maybe a Stretch. Just trying to clear the area here for the Demons. All flying from all directions. It's Jones who just, gee, he'd be a bit dirty, I reckon, Liam Jones at the moment. He's had Mark of the Day taken off him, and he's had a couple of cracks at it himself. So the ball will be tossed in on centre wing. 31 playing 10. Blues leading the Demons. Now the sun's starting to come out too. It's Mother's Day. Phillips is being held by the jumper by King. Not King, I should say. Kilty. And he'll take the free kick. True centre wing position. Kicks up the line looking for Jax. You can hear the thud off his hands. Moncrief gang tackled over the line. And we'll have it thrown in.
It's been a very physical game, boys, and it'll be interesting to see the second half to see which team handles that the best.
16 minutes gone in the second term. 31 plays 10. As the ball tossed back into play. And Phillips getting the ruckwork duties. Wilson back to Gallucci. Ball getting back inside 50, Armfield creating the contest. Hutchins on the last line of defence. Handball smothered. Here's Dennis. He's being held. Dragged out. Free kick.
Yeah,
well, because he set the pace there, yep. He's just flying along.
Just panicked a little, didn't he, Vanderhaar? And that's what happens, Pete, when you've got that explosiveness. Everyone around you realises that it's a dangerous place to be.
He really showed his experience there, didn't he, Leedsy, with just not taking that ball, just a little tap on.
Certainly
not to take the ball.
So here's Dennis Armfield. Fan favourite. Great to see players named Dennis in the competition still. He won't be too favourite after that because he's just missed. Missed to the left-hand side.
And you know, and it's kick, on here.
And they're getting into him too. And they are in big time. He didn't like the attention because they were reminding him Kerr's being dragged down by Hillard. And now they're all getting involved. It has Hutchins getting in there. And Dennis Armfield on the goal line. In fact, the top of the square will have the free kick. Meanwhile, there's a lot of jumper tugging going on. Wilson trying to get in there. Hutchins just clearing the area. They all break up. Umpire in a good position. But meanwhile, he's going to have another go at it. And he put it through this time, Dennis. No mistake. Second time around and they get to him too. Now, after all of that, it ends up being a 7-point play for the Blues. So the fight breaks up and the Blues bank the 7 points. And Dennis Armfield relieved that he had another go at that one because his first attempt wasn't all that great, let's be honest.
And what started it is that he was absolutely into Vanderhaar once he got the free kick. He let him know all about it, and then as soon as he missed, half of the Casey's side went to let him know that return serve was well and truly on its way. And all of a sudden, the 7-point play. Oh, who'd be a coach? Back in the middle. Knockdown. Cunningham couldn't take it. Polson almost. He did second time. Knocked out of his hands. Next crucial clearance goes to Casey. If only momentarily. As Sheehan's going to meet it at halfback. Got it away to Buckley. Tries to run away from Kennedy Harris. Kept going to Jay. But couldn't affect the kick from Kerridge enough. It's knocked to half forward. No real mark. A chance for Hillard. Under all sorts of pressure from Kerr. And the umpire comes in and he will toss it up 52 away from the Blues goal line.
So 5-7, 37, 1-4, 10 is the score as I have it at the moment.
Chance for Dwyer, got it away, under all sorts of pressure, Harms, he's well tackled. Good stuff from Polson. This is a good game of footy, plenty of feeling all of a sudden, but Casey need to put it on the board. Not just the scuffling stuff as Phillips goes early, knocked it down. Cunningham couldn't take it. Little handball out of traffic from Dwyer. Liked his game so far. All trouble here for Harms. Tried to get away from Polson, couldn't. Munro, who was right in the thick of it earlier. Oh, gee, big hit. Well done, Dwyer. Just rode it nicely. And then another one for Kennedy Harris, but it's Cunningham who comes up with it. Oh, Buckley drives it long.
He
taken after
here,
he got rid of it. And now game, there'll be pressure from everywhere for Hillard.
Well,
the Blues come to him. The mummified Hillard has four to deal with. As they start to close, I think common sense is going to prevail. Buckley's up.
And it's 50 down the ground too. So it means that Jack's going to take it downfield because Buckley was dealt with. He released the footy. And then just Hillard came in so hard on that contest and took it completely out of play. Well, and had so much momentum on it that Hillard went to ground as well as Buckley.
Jack's the man. And he gets the goal. So Casey have just taken their eye off it here. Cost themselves 13 points in the last 3 minutes. They've been physical, but unfortunately in all the wrong places. And the Northern Blues have a commanding lead at the 20-minute mark of the second term. Whew.
Well, and it's a lonely place to be, Hilly, because I'm looking at Brenton Hillard now, who's inside defensive 50 for Casey. No teammates around him at all. Well, they are filthy on him. But it's just that retaining that composure, because it was such that we saw a couple of hard acts right in front of you leading up to that contest. Yeah. But it's just maintaining, keeping your head. 6-8-44 playing 1-4-10.
It certainly felt like retaliation, and it's cost him a goal.
So, off the ground, Cunningham putting it into the path of Gallucci, past him, Hutchins for Casey, being harassed here by Gallucci, and Gallucci picked it up, did well, off to Kerr, 52 metres out, putting the ball in a dangerous position. Jax picked it up, he couldn't, just had to paddle in front of him, working their collars, clearing the area to Hutchins. Just need to slow down here. There's Harms, short ball, Neil Bullen. The players running in the middle of the ground. This is going to be dangerous, although they still have the numbers here if they can just be clean with their disposal. Second, third effort's good as the kick going across the ground is okay. And the mark taken by Scott. Over the top he goes into the path of Neil Bullen. 52 from goal. Not a bad kick. The contest was there. Working around the body, not happy with it. Johnston has left the boots through for a behind. 1-5-11, playing 6-8-44. There have been a flurry of scores for the Blues. We'll just confirm that at half time. 22 gone in this second quarter.
So Keppel has it in the back pocket for the Blues. He heads with a long ball to the outer side. Nice set at the back and a big fly, but no mark is fisted forward by Sumner. Kept his composure as he was going to ground. Knocked it 30 metres, but Hutchins was there to mop up. A little handball here for Kennedy Harris. Short ball, okay, for Neil Balloon, who's working his way into it nicely. Heads to the outer flank. Some space for Ferreira. Goes one way, then the other. Left foot kick deep into the pockets, over the line.
Out of
bounds on the full. Nothing going right for Casey just at the minute. 44-11. Blues in front. And with the footy in the back pocket. A long, high ball, out of trouble. Phillips the target at ground level. This is Ferreira. Kicks to the pocket. Can he measure a little better here? Fritsch the target, knocked towards the line. And that was good stuff from McCready. It'll be tossed back in a metre round from the point post. Casey attacking at the city end, but trailing 1-5-11 to 6-8-44 at the 22-minute mark of this second term.
Earlier today, a win for Box Hill over Richmond. We'll bring you a score from Piranha Park in just a moment as Phillips getting the tap down. Bokehurst running onto it, running around Neil Bullen and putting up a high ball that does Sumner no favours. Flying high was Harms. It's over the boundary line. We'll have it thrown in.
Three-quarter time, Fremantle 9-11-65, Richmond 5-5-35.
Seeing Declan Kilty there on the bench, preparing a whole range of players to come back on as trying to find a way through his stretch. He's tackled and going nowhere. The umpire will throw the ball up half forward for the Demons, who trail 44-11 coming up at half time. Replay an interview from Monday night's VFL Rewind featuring Jacob Ballard. Out of the pack here, Kennedy Harris, long shot at goals. Got the distance, not the accuracy. Another behind. 1-6-12, play 6-8-44, Blues leading. The kick in is good and quick, and it's working there. Kerridge has got Dylan Buckley, who kicked it to him running past. That's ignored. Buckley still on his own. He's got to be careful here. McCready finds Lamb. Ferreira just lost his footing temporarily. Keppel has it. Oh, a little low ball, not the greatest. Kerridge works it back to Lamb, who finds Wilson, who kicks up the line. Kick is good. Jacks on the lead. Long lead too. On centre wing, Hutchins, the skipper of Casey, on the mark. He goes back and across the ground to Keppel at defensive 50. Wants to switch to the broadcast side. He's kicked looking for O'Shea, who's got a bit of room on this side. Handball across to Buckley, who goes by hand looking for Pickett. Good shepherding work away from the contest. Well, almost good shepherding work. Need to do a little bit more there, Cunningham, just to provide that shepherding protection. And working here is Bokehurst in the middle of the ground. His kick is okay, and now they're on. Wilson gets a handball received from Lamb. He kicks a long high ball into the pocket, and Sumner's taken the mark, and he'll line up and have a shot 25 metres out. Plenty of goal face to look at, even though he is on the angle. A chance at their seventh goal here, Hilly.
Yes, and when the Blues look to change the angles as they make their way up the field, that's when they look the most dangerous. And they certainly were looking like they would come the outer side, then they switched and then came back through the middle. And as soon as they did that, they really opened Casey Demons right up.
So Liam Sumner kicked a goal in the opening quarter. Steps in now and kicks his second. This is a handy break for the Blues now. 7-8-50, plays 1-6-12. As we close in on quarter time, we've played 26 minutes in this second quarter.
Trouble, isn't it? Looks dangerous now for Casey, who, as we said, just the one win coming into today against North Ballarat. They've lost to Werribee, Geelong and Williamstown. None of those losses being too significant in margin, but things aren't looking good here this afternoon.
They just haven't built that momentum that they had last year. Obviously, it was such a successful year for the Casey Demons. And, yeah, they just haven't built any momentum yet into the season.
We're restarted again as the ball to be won at half back, and is by Collis for the Demons. Neil Bullen's been everywhere. Harms, little ball across the ground, dodgy one, no good, the bounce for King. He tried to lay a tackle, support arrives through Collis, got the handball away, Neil Bullen's there to support, well played, got it to Hutchins, who can just square them off across the ground and head to Trengove on the outer side. He asks a lot there, and it was never going to be a mark for Gent because Sheen had the sit, and he comes back in board to Paulson. Oh, dodgy little ball, but okay in the end because it was made good off by Kerridge, who handballed away to a running Buckley. He was running so fast he couldn't make good contact. Oh, it fell off the arms of the Demons. Jack picks it up, and then the bounce was horrible for him. That wasn't a good advertisement. The last 5 seconds of footy there. Went through for one behind. 51-12. It's the Blues in front.
Christian Jacks has looked very dangerous today. He was very impressive the last time that we saw him. He's certainly starting to piece together some good form.
As Harms goes long outside the 50, Jones flies, can't take the mark. Kilty is there, it's off hands, there's a siren. Scott can't run a long way inside 50. That did have a lot ahead of him. And that quarter again goes to the Northern Blues as we keep an eye on the players here just to see whether there are any sort of spot fires breaking out. It was a fiery quarter. In the end, the Blues managed to kick clear. They are 7 goals, 9-51, playing 1 goal, 6-12. Gee, inaccurate kicking from the Demons. They kicked 5 behinds. 1 goal, 5 in that quarter to 4 goals, 5 for the Northern Blues. And it's the Northern Blues with a commanding lead at halftime. The goal kickers to halftime. 2 goals each to Christian Jacks and Liam Sumner. And singles to Wilson, Armfield and Lebois. And for Casey, J. Kennedy Harris, their solitary goal kicker, and that was in the second quarter. Repeating the injury news from a little bit earlier, Angus Brayshaw received a heavy knock in the opening, well, minute or so of the game. He was taken from the ground. He wasn't knocked out or anything like that, but did have some concussion testing, and as we heard from Glenn Hill, he's taking no further part in the game. Earlier today, around the grounds, it was Box Hill getting the job done over Richmond, and it's Sandringham working their way back into the contest at Piranha Park. They've hit the lead by 5 points late in the second quarter up the road from where we are here at the Preston City Oval. And Fremantle getting the job done against the Tigers at the MCG. A break. On the other side of the break, we'll be hearing from a young Tiger, Jacob Ballard, who's made his way into the initial squad for the state game coming up in a couple of weeks' time. He caught up with the team from VFL Rewind. We'll have that for you next at halftime here on Peter Jackson, VFL Live.
I'm a digital radio.
And I'm a digital TV. Now, you may remember when TV went digital.
Yes, yes, and you got a lot more channels and a better picture.
Well, buying a digital radio is the same.
Exactly. I've got up to 30 extra radio stations, plus all your old faves, uh-huh. And I sound amazing.
Yeah, but I look amazing.
Yeah, but this is a radio ad, so no one can see you.
Oh, yeah.
So if you want to hear this station like you have never heard it before,
buy a digital radio.
Head into your nearest retailer and upgrade to digital.
Last year, Vision Australia helped more than 33,000 people who are blind or have low vision. So if you find that glasses are no longer helping and you're struggling to complete daily tasks, why not give us a call? Our free services, provided by specialist staff, can help increase your independence. We also offer advice on equipment and provide training in how to travel around safely with limited vision. Vision Australia can help you make a real difference. Call us now, 1300 847 466.
Love your sport? Then you'll love SEN.
1-2, Jamie Wink up first. Craig Lowndes second.
And you'll find it on digital radio. Simply scroll to SEN, Melbourne's home of sport.
I'm a digital radio. To help explain why it's time to update your old radio, with me is my friend Digital TV.
Hi.
There you go.
Remember when us TVs went digital?
Everyone does. Get to the point.
Suddenly, you got lots more channels for free.
Yes.
Well, it's the same with digital radio.
When you buy a digital radio, you can get all your favourite stations, plus up to 30 extra ones, playing all kinds of music, live, sport and talk.
That's pretty great.
It's really great.
All you have to do is head into your nearest retailer.
Or check out digitalradioplus.com.au.
And upgrade to digital.
The Red Time Sport iPhone app is here and ready to download. The app allows you to listen to the different sports BPM media broadcasts wherever you are in the world, including VFL and TAC Cup radio and a whole lot more. You can interact with the commentary team in real time via the Red Time Sport iPhone app feedback and social networking buttons. Plus, check out upcoming broadcasts. Catch up with the latest sports headlines from around the world via the Sports News button. The Red Time Sport iPhone app. Download it from the iTunes Store today. Visit bpmmedia.com.au for more details.
Next week, Peter Jackson VFL Live is at Burbank Oval for the Round 6 clash between Williamstown and Richmond. That's next Sunday afternoon from 1:45, live on the Red Time Sport iPhone app and audio and video stream through vfl.com.au.
Peter Jackson VFL Live, online, on digital radio and the Red Time Sport iPhone app.
Half time here at the Preston City Oval, and it is a commanding lead. 7-9-51, the Northern Blues to the KC Demons, 1-6-12. A very good quarter there from the Blues, although it was all KC in the first couple of minutes, and then the Blues with a rush getting the job done and piling on four goals in that quarter. Earlier it was a win for Box Hill over the Richmond side today. Speaking of Richmond, Jacob Bellard, young player on the Tigers VFL list, has made it into the initial squad for the state game coming up in a couple of weeks' time at Northport Oval. That list to be further reduced down over the next week or so. But it's been an interesting journey, an interesting path for Jacob Bellard, taking him all around the country. And he caught up with the team from VFL Rewind, Anthony Stangerts and Paul Hooper on 94.13 WBC last Monday night to talk about his journey and the excitement of being at the Tigers and also in the state squad.
Great to have you on board. Tell us a little bit about your career. It's taken you west. It's brought you back to Victoria. Tell us a little bit where were you initially drafted from and what's got you back to Victoria.
It's been a bit of a trip around the country. So, started off as a junior playing in my local town of Warrandyte in the northeast suburbs of Melbourne.
Love the Bloods.
And then went on to the Northern Knights for the TAP Cup from there, and then was quite disappointed as an 18-year-old. I had high hopes of getting drafted, but unfortunately missed out as an 18-year-old, and then went through the process of the feeder club, which was Northern Blues for the Northern Knights at the time, and had a season there and played okay, but didn't think I did anything too spectacular, and got a surprise call-up in the rookie draft to be drafted by Freo, and that was pretty amazing. And then, spent 2 years over west with Fremantle, and had a great experience there. Loved my time there, but unfortunately got delisted after two seasons, now I'm with Richmond VFL going into my second season there, and loving my time there so far.
Jacob, welcome to the program. It's Anthony Stangerts. It's a bit of a family reunion for the Northern Knights down at the Richmond Football Club at VFL and AFL level, with plenty of former Knights on both lists.
Yeah, exactly. It's pretty crazy, actually. The amount of Knights boys they've picked up. I don't know what the link is there, but obviously they've taken a liking to the talent produced at the Northern Knights.
And we must say congratulations on your nomination for the state team for the VFL. What was it like when you found out the news that you're in the initial squad?
Yeah, thanks for that, guys. It was great news, obviously. Probably wasn't really thinking about it. Didn't play in it last year or anything, so I wasn't too sure about the timing of those sorts of things. But when Hully, our head of football at VFL at Richmond, sent me a text to let me know I was in the squad, I was pretty stoked.
And pretty good to be in there with the captain Sam Daly as well in that initial squad who played last year.
Yeah, it's great having Daly there as well. He's a great bloke, and get along real well with him, so it'll be good to have someone to drive down to training with or make me feel a bit more comfortable there, so that'd be good.
What's he like as captain of the club? Because he joined Richmond's VFL team at the same time as yourself.
I didn't know Dales before getting to Richmond, but he's been great. He's one of those guys Just one of those guys you love having around a footy club. Really outgoing, really friendly, quite loud, loves a bit of banter, loves a chat. And he's just one of those guys that really, really love having at the footy club and just really keeps the place buzzing and good atmosphere around the club.
And what's it been like for yourself this season? The 14 games, 8 goals last year. How are you finding your role in that Richmond VFL team in season 2017?
It's been great. It's been pretty much a similar role to what I played last year, just playing through the inside mid as one of our main midfielders on the VFL list. Really enjoying that. Then just been enjoying spending a little bit more time up forward as well. This year with some of our new structures and game plan gives some of our bigger bodied mids a bit of a chance to rest up as our deepest and going to the bench and resting all the time. So I've enjoyed that side of the game and swinging forward and just trying to get a few easy ones out the back. It's been nice.
And Jacob, you're only 23, but it seems like you've been around for a long time. 2 years over in the West, and in the year that you were delisted, you actually won the Best and Fairest for Peel Thunder. So you've been in good form. Do you feel that your AFL dream is over, or do you still harbour, hope for maybe another recall?
I guess, you never want to say die, never say it's over. So I guess, I enjoy playing at the highest level possible, so I was always going to keep playing at VFL for a while after getting delisted, but it does also keep my options open if the chance was to come up and get redrafted. So, yeah, it's definitely there at the back of the mind, but definitely not the be-all and end-all, and I've learned through my time getting delisted from Fremantle that you need to have some other things as a plan B and do some stuff outside of football, so I'm pretty focused on that, and anything else that happens is just a bonus for me, really.
Were you tempted after winning that Best and Fairest at Peel Thunder to maybe stay in WA and continue your career at waffle level, or was it an easy decision to get back to Melbourne?
I did really love my time in WA, but probably it was a pretty easy decision just to come back to Melbourne and just have that support circle and Cree. Live a bit close to family and friends. A lot of my mates over there were all pretty much tied up and through the football club, and they were always going to be on quite a different schedule to them. So I figured I wouldn't have seen them as much, and it might have been a bit harder. So I thought, yeah, it was a pretty simple decision to come back to Melbourne.
And Jacob, have you had a chance to have a look at the Waffle initial squad to see if any former teammates or opponents you might be heading up against if you make the final team?
No, I haven't actually had a chance to have a look. I'm not too sure, actually.
Okay, well, we'll try and have a look at that.
But good.
We also mentioned your new role, drifting down into the forward line a bit more. It's a new look forward line for Richmond at VFL level. We've been very used to seeing Liam McBean up there leading the goal kicking at VFL level, but you've got the likes of Lennon, Lloyd, Chole's been drifting down there as well. So a bit of a new exciting look for that VFL Tigers list.
Yeah, definitely. I think it is quite a versatile forward line. We've got a few different players that can go through there. So like I said, with our bigger body mids, that gives us a bit of a weapon. So we've got guys like Jacob Townsend, Brandon Wood, Anthony Miles when he's been playing, usually drifting forward. But then obviously Benny Lennon's been awesome for us. He's been kicking bags. Marbs has been drifting forward and providing a good key tall target. And then usually we've got a few, our side stacked with a few ruckmen with Ivan Maric and Soldo. So, yeah, we've got plenty of options going through there. And then we've got the small guys as well, some of the first-year draftees in Tice and Shea. So, yeah, there's plenty of different options up there.
And you talk about Shea Bolton. He's a bit of an excitement machine. I've seen some of his goals and his work around that forward 50 arc, and you never know what you're going to expect from him, and it'd be handy at AFL level for the Tigers.
Yeah. I think he's definitely shown some glimpses and plenty of upside of what he can bring. Bit of X factor. Some of the highlights that we sometimes we just have vision of some of the good things from the games and some of the marks he sort of takes and then just sort of plays on and sort of sells a dummy to the man on the mark, and just his change of direction and his agility is pretty outstanding. So yeah, I think plenty of upside there.
Now, Jacob, since you've returned from WA, what's been keeping you busy off the field, work-wise or study-wise?
Yeah, got a few things going. So I actually started a degree. The year I got drafted, just part-time, something that was a double degree that I started in law and psychology. But since then, I've made a few changes and actually dropped out of the law side of things after getting a few units done with that, and then went into state psychology, and just been actually today in at the Latrobe Uni office today, looking to transfer again into another double degree, but keeping the psychology and doing a bit of commerce and finance. So, I've changed my mind a few times, but it's all a bit of a process trying to feel my way through it and work out what I actually enjoy and what I want to do in the future.
Whatever happened to footballers being plumbers and stuff like that? You could be handy around a football club, because, as you know, there's a few mental cases at football clubs that could do with it, some psychologist help over the journey.
Yeah, no, I think it's just becoming, people are beginning to realise how important mental health is, especially in elite sports and football as well. So I guess, yeah, it's good that there is a lot of stigma being reduced and people are sort of coming out and talking about those sorts of things like depression and mental health issues. So, but yeah, I think it's a very important topic, and I think as elite sportsmen, we're sort of role models, and anyone who talks about that sort of stuff, I think it's great, and it's just going to make the world a better place.
Well said. Jacob Ballard there from the Richmond VFL side. That from VFL Rewind, which you can catch every Monday from 7 o'clock on 3WBC 94.1 here in Melbourne and on the website as well. And then throughout the week on vfl.com.au, that recorded prior to the Tigers' loss to Box Hill earlier today. We'll go around the grounds on the other side of the break. Both sides out on the ground getting ready for the second half here. 7-9-51 the Blues, Demons 1-6-12. Third quarter next on Peter Jackson, VFL Live.
I'm a digital radio. To help explain why it's time to update your old radio, with me is my friend Digital TV.
Hi.
Where you go?
Remember when us TVs went digital?
Everyone does. Get to the point.
Suddenly, you got lots more channels for free.
Yes.
Well, it's the same with digital radio.
When you buy a digital radio, you can get all your favourite stations, plus up to 30 extra ones, playing all kinds of music, live sport and talk.
That's pretty great.
It's really great.
All you have to do is head into your nearest retailer.
Or check out digitalradioplus.com.au.
And upgrade to digital.
Last year, Vision Australia helped more than 33,000 people who are blind or have low vision. So if you find that glasses are no longer helping and you're struggling to complete daily tasks, why not give us a call? Our free services, provided by specialist staff, can help increase your independence. We also offer advice on equipment and provide training in how to travel around safely with limited vision. Vision Australia can help you make a real difference. Call us now, 1-300-847-466.
Love your sport? Then you'll love SEN.
1-2, Jamie Wick up first, Craig Lowndes second.
And you'll find it on digital radio. Simply scroll to SEN, Melbourne's home of sport.
The Red Time Sport iPhone app is here and ready to download. The app allows you to listen to the different sports BPM media broadcasts wherever you are in the world, including VFL and TAC Cup radio and a whole lot more. You can interact with the commentary team in real time via the Red Time Sport iPhone app feedback and social networking buttons. Plus, check out upcoming broadcasts. Catch up with the latest sports headlines from around the world via the Sports News button. The Red Time Sport iPhone app. Download it from the iTunes Store today. Visit bpmmedia.com.au for more details.
On Aussie Digital, streaming live through vfl.com.au and on the Red Time Sport iPhone app, this is Peter Jackson, VFL Live.
Getting set now for the third quarter. Sides getting into position. It's the Northern Blues 7-9-51
to Casey, 1-6-12 around the grounds. The match at the MCG tightening up, Leedsy.
It is, 9 points the margin, Fremantle in front. Here, 39 points the margin as we're underway in this second half. It'll be Phillips and Keane to go at it. Beautiful bounce to get us started. Big fist forward from Phillips, but little effect off the volleyball spike. It came to Neil Bullen. Beautiful kick to half forward. Kilty in front. Got the handball away. Working hard, Mitch Gent. Got to go back and get it after missing it initially. He did, but then he was beset upon. And despite the appeals from the local crowd, there wasn't a free kick forthcoming. You got more scores from around the grounds,
Pete? I do, yeah. Half time up at Piranha Park. 8-3-51, Coburg, Sandringham, 7-2-44.
So Russell couldn't quite get a handle on it. Here's Armfield out the back. Trouble now. Gent got his hands in the way. Did well, but he was well tackled. The Blues have been disciplined today. Kerry's continuing that theme early in the third term. 51-12. Early going in this third quarter. Phillips and King. We'll give this one to Phillips out the back. It was Jed Lamb looking inboard for Russell. Stolen away. Kennedy got a handball on as far as Lamb. Here's Buckley, tried to get it away to Shin. That was okay. Jones in the back half now, put his team under all sorts of pressure. McCready was up to the task, though, got it back to Jones. And then on his right boot, sets them up nicely as he finds Russell at half-back. His kick smothered, turnover might be on.
Yeah, the player in front of him smothering. Gee, they've got to work on their kicking there. A lot of smothered kicks, I've noticed this year. Here's Armfield having to battle here. He's under all sorts of pressure. Collis bearing down on him. Managed to get away to Lamb. They're on the run here now. The Blues up centre wing. Kerr with a handball over the top into a good position. Working his way around Cunningham. Cunningham looking for Korchek. It's going to be turned over, though. Moncrief takes the relieving mark back pocket for the Demons. His kick is okay. Finds Scott. Well inside the defensive 50 for Casey. Interesting to know what Justin Plapp said to the boys at half time. It's a turnover here. Pickett coming in to take the mark. We've got a few players in a little bit of space. And Kerr is the one calling for in the pocket. Heads that direction. It's not Kerr who he's going to go to. Work this out okay. Paulson has to give the handball out. Hutchings laying the tackle. And it's locked in. The umpire will throw it up.
Fremantle point, 10 points to margin.
How long to go there?
We're 5:50 remaining.
Hilly, down to you on the boundary line.
I was just going to say, just repeating myself again, Jared Pickett certainly looking a lot better behind the play today, so might have found himself a new role in this team.
Repeating two, if you're just joining us, Angus Brayshaw copped a heavy knock in the opening minute of the game, and he is not taking any further part in this contest. Meanwhile, there's a free kick going the Blues' way. Paulson, 52 from goal, kicking into the pocket, looking for Kerr, who was dealt with. He puts his hands up. The umpire says, I'm not interested, and we'll have it thrown in.
That free kick just a moment ago, Pete, was for a sling tackle, and there's been quite a few today, and certainly the VFL will be looking on and certainly assessing the way the game's been played today.
Yeah, the umps advisors in front of us here, Cameron Nash, the head of the umpires here today, so I would have made a note of that as ball off hands. Quick kick Lamb, straight into the pack in front of him. It does go back. Russell has to get the handball at Barkley. Around one, around two, has to retreat ground. Jones, he's got a big leg. He kicks a long ball all the way to the goal square mark. Oh, they set it up well, the Blues. And it's just wave after wave of pressure, and Jax has got a top of the goal square.
Great play from Buckley initially there. He could have tried to take on a couple of tacklers, but instead retreated, found the loose player in Jones, and it'll end up being a goal for the Blues.
Yep, and he put it straight through. That's their eighth. They move to 8-9-57, playing 1-6-12. Jax with one in each of the quarters now. He's got the set. As we have played in this third quarter, 5 minutes. Meanwhile, at the MCG.
Gee, Dusty Martin just beat two in the forward 50 to set up Revolt, who missed from 30 out on a slight angle. Tigers still in at 9 points the margin, 4.5 to go. Here, Casey in desperate need of a run on. They need to get moving in a real hurry now as the Seagulls set themselves on a commentary wing.
Williamstown's not playing today.
No, they're just a little lost. Bounce down again. Beautiful to watch that high bounce. Phillips got it down. Kennedy, can he get first hands on it? He did. Got the handball away. Good stuff in the air. Neil Bullen squeezed the kick to half forward. Keppel tried to get it going towards the line. He couldn't. Kilty put his head over it. Might have been taken high. Allowed to go on. Blues have the numbers. Out the back, Russell a chance. He's got Kennedy Harris bearing down, so he kicks quickly to the wing. Jax has got first posse on this one. Did well. Got the handball away. Needs to get back and support. Tackle. And it's against Hillard. And now Jax has just got a little bit to say to Hillard. He's got the footy, doesn't want to give it away.
See, he's got the bandaging off now, Hillard. Still got the number four, though.
Oh, Jax has turned it over. What can they do here? Tringove has it. Goes through the middle of the ground. He can't find his man. Nice pickup, though. On the one, on the half volley there from Scott Little, left footer. No good. Turned it over. The Blues will come away through O'Shea. High ball and a good mark from Moncrief as Casey try and launch from the half-back flank.
It works it to Munro. Munro kicking to that outer side into the path of Billy Stretch, takes the mark.
Tigers within 3 points.
Oh, just that lid needs to just remain in an on position. There's the kick from Billy Stretch going up the line. And again, just the defensive mark from Jones. He's having a good time of it. He's having a wonderful time of it. William Jones playing down in defence. Finds Russell. The kick across the ground for Jax. Up the line. This is working out okay. LeBois, who kicks inside the 50. Mark not taken by Korchek. It falls to the back. Gorringe, brought down by Moncrief, got it away to Armfield, who just unselfishly goes backwards to Sheehan, who takes the mark. And he'll line up and have a shot 40 outs.
Smart footy, wasn't it?
Speaking of shots, what's happening in the MCG?
Grigg from 50 to put the Tigers in front, misses to the left-hand side. 2 points the margin there.
So Kieran Sheehan, chance to extend the margin here for the Northern Blues. Overcast all of a sudden. We had the sun out for a while, but the haze has returned. As Jed Lamb sprints back out onto the ground. Meanwhile, Kieran Sheehan, deliberate run-up, 45 metres out, hasn't worked, it's across the face, and snuck in for a behind. 8-10-58, plays 1-6-12. Third quarter action here on Peter Jackson VFL Live. We've played 8 minutes.
So what can Casey get going here? You can hear in the effects, Mike, the fans just getting a little frustrated with what they're seeing. Oh, I thought it might have been trouble for Tringo, but he was good enough to take it from Hewlett from the kick in. He heads across the ground and finds Munro deep in the back pocket. He heads out now to the run of King. That was well played by the big fella. Oh, the kick a little dodgy though. Allows the Blues in and they're on now. Lamb, handball to Korchek, away to Jones. Inside the 50, one-on-one. Good fist away, but good stuff from Armfield to keep his feet. Handball over the top. Goal coming up to Sumner. It's another one. This time the turnover in the middle of the ground cost Casey and the Blues get their ninth of the afternoon. They're 9-10-64. Casey Demons 1-6-12, 9 gone third term, and this has all sorts of smashing written all over it.
Sure does, Leedsy, and the body language is not good from Casey at the moment. There's a lot of hands on hips and slow walking back to position. They really look like they're going to get touched up here.
Well, you just saw there, that handball from Armfield, three players were goal side of the contest.
Yeah, it's what happens when you turn it over in the middle, isn't it?
With three players, though, inside the 50, streaming towards goal. They had all sorts of options. Good composure, too, from Armfield. This should be rebounced. It will be in the middle of the ground. It's more than favouring Mitch King, who was about to gobble it up. Meanwhile, MCG, what's happening?
Still 2 points the margin. A minute and a half to go. Tigers have it on the wing.
There's Phillips, secondary tap down. Ball ends up with Ferreira. Defensive side of the square, he's turned it over. Now the Blues going forward. Lamb, high ball, top of the goal square. The fist comes in on Kerr. He's pulsing though. He picks it up and kicks another one. Cam Paulson is a handy player. This Northern Blues list as well. And they've added another one to the total. They've kicked three already in this quarter. And they're 10-10-70 playing 1-6-12. 10 minutes gone in this third quarter. Signs ominous, as the boys have talked about, and the lead continues to grow. But focus on the Northern Blues for a moment. They've been ultra impressive today. They've really got their forward set up right, Hilly.
They certainly have, and Josh Fraser's got them playing very, very tough football, well structured.
They've improved a lot this year.
Yeah, Brand becoming almost as recognisable as the waft of snags here up in the grandstand, doing a great job as the Scorpions come away with it. Stretch on the stretch with his left, wants to square it up to 45. King goes back, great courage, spills out the back, chance for Fritsch. He had a couple to beat though. Sheehan just in all sorts of trouble there. Did he get it out? No, the umpire said no. Opportunity.
Tigers in front. Tigers in front by 4 points with 21 seconds to go.
Oh dear, they've come from a long way behind in the last quarter. Here's Casey, they'll need to do something similar here. Handball deep into the pocket. Neil Bullen, was his kick smothered? No, he got away, but just a little shallow and misses to the near side. 1-7-13, trailing 10-10-70 as the Blues bring it back in quickly. Jack's on the end of it, goes down the line. You give me a final score when it comes through, Pete. Chance now for Casey as the turnover's on. Collis goes in with his left boot. Couldn't find his teammate. Oh, good stuff, McCready. Nice spin out of trouble there. Comes down the line. Collis fists it towards the line. And Pete?
I haven't won yet. There's the set of bounce, 21 seconds to go.
Oh, watch the footy here. You keep an eye on that one.
Oh, they've got the set of clearance here, the Dockers. And the mark too. The siren's going to go. They had a kick after the siren here, the Dockers.
Mundy is 1-1 for shots after the siren. Plenty of pressure for him here. It's a Casey kick. We'll keep you up to date with what's going on there. As
the siren's gone, so it's going to be kick after the siren, Leedsy.
Neil Bullen heads to the pocket. Jones, good fist over the line ahead of King. And they'll toss it in 10 metres around while Mundy gets himself set for the shot to win the game for Fremantle against Richmond at the G.
Got to say, Liam Jones's vertical leap is exceptional.
Yeah, he's played a very complete game today. Ball back in. Phillips just come over the top, Pete, with news.
He's kicked it.
Oh,
he's
Fremantle.
He's kicked the goal.
Kick after the siren.
Oh, yeah. Freo win.
Blues trying to get it out of the back 50. What a game of footy. Here, Casey trying to work it inside the arc. A little handball out the back. Chance for Tringove. Sold a bit of candy. And then he was beset upon. Umpire said he got rid of it. Blues fans couldn't believe it. Another big tackle inside the 50. And they'll toss it up. 40 out directly in front.
Look at my monitor here. Look at the Tigers fans. They can't believe that they've lost. Kick after the siren. 21 seconds they had to just hang on for. They all went running down to defensive 50, but they still had time. It's a quick kick out of the pack here. Well, it's just a tough day here for Casey. Just can't find a path to goal. And yet again, it's been cut off. And yet again, the safe hands of the Blues defence. Here's Dylan Buckley. We're going to score from Shiner in a moment as the kick going long. Jack's 3-3. Gee, you made a fist of that contest. Did a good job of it in the end. But plenty of numbers here working through harms. Just off a step, kicks up towards the 50. Now can take the mark. Trying to work his way through was Kennedy. Coughed it up, Sheehan. Working back, Russell. Across to Buckley near the boundary line at half back. And he's given one over the boundary line by Ferreira. And he wants to go after Ferreira too. He was dealt with as soon as that ball went over the line and the umpire's whistle. So we wait for it to be tossed in. Into attack here for the Demons. All on his own there was Kilty. His ball going absolutely nowhere and the umpire will come in and intervene.
13 points the margin for Port Adelaide against Gold Coast and Coburg by 7 points at the main change against Sandringham.
Many thousands of kilometres separating those two venues today as the ball... Yeah, handball over the top. Kennedy Harris has got a couple to beat and we'll have it thrown in. 25 around now from the Casey goal. 70 plays 13. 15 gone in this third quarter. The Coburg City Oval. Toss back in. Jones getting front position in the ruck contest, but they might get out here, Harms. Wheeling it back out. Munro running into trouble was Kennedy Harris. We threw a couple back to Munro. Dangerous. Brought down Dwyer. Lost a handle on it. Ball dribbling towards the goal line. That's a heavy tackle from Ferreira. And it's too high. And Sheehan will take the free kick. So, again, just the good pressure from the Northern Blues defence. He's kicked a little short ball. They're out here anyway. As Pickett goes over the top.
not the greatest to Keppel, but he just kept running. Second, third efforts were okay. Still couldn't control the footy, though, and it's in dispute. It's right near the boundary line, and Neil Bullen will see it over and will have it tossed in. So 70 playing 13. Blues commanding position, overcast conditions, hazy conditions here at the Preston City Oval today.
Goals to Kabadia and Allen. See Coburg 63 to Sandringham 44. So Lions on the march there. Here it's all about the Blues as they try and go forward. We're on the outer wing. Picked up by Tringove, who's starting to get his hands on the footy plenty of times. Casey with the better of the last couple of minutes. Can they put it on the board? Here's a chance for Kennedy Harris, one way then the other. Goes on his right boot, heads to the pocket, misses the target, out of bounds on the full. It'll be a Blues ball, back pocket. As Jones finds his target, little chip over the top. Keppel in the back pocket. Nice ball here in short for Sheehan. He's going to go on his left. On the mark. On the mark is Russell, who takes it. Heads to the outer flank. Dodgy old kick. Arcelot and got a good answer from Pickett, who stole it away and then darted through a couple of players. Got the handball away. They're off to the races now. Can they make the most of it? Long kick to half forward. Jack's the target. He's got Cunningham out the back. It won't matter. Jack's is off to the races. There's five Blues all in their own in the goal square having a tea party. Jax nails the goal, and this is becoming very ugly in a hurry for Casey. 11-10-76 to Casey, 1-7-13-17, gone third term.
Well, you called it right, Leedsy. From that hilly, when that ball went inside 50, there were five unmarked Northern Blues players all around that footy.
Oh, they're just sprinting hard from the contest, and that's where they've really got them on the turnovers today. They certainly have worked harder from the contest and around the contest. They're winning all divisions at the moment.
Just extraordinary on that turnover, just slicing through the middle. It all started with Jared Pickett at half back. So back in the middle, Korchek getting the ball down nicely, and they get some more run here as Kerridge back inside the 50. A few more numbers back there for Casey this time. Hutchins works it back out to Tringove, who has to pick it up. Tackled by Gallucci. Turnover. Here's Sumner getting the ball around his body, and Paulson takes the mark.
Just so loose, Pete. They're just so loose, the Casey defenders.
This has got three figures written all over it right now.
Mm.
Three figures. There's Paulson. Whistle. Blood rule. Blood rule down the ground, back in the middle of the ground.
Just can't get a picture on that player at the moment.
I think it might be Sean Dwyer.
He's got a lot of blood.
Yep, here he comes.
Various places heading towards you for a bit of patch-up work. Meanwhile, Cam Paulson has already kicked a goal in this quarter. Just being told to wait. Now he can get back on with it. Time back on. In he comes. Paulson makes no mistake. Absolutely no mistake. And the procession continues. Two goals for Paulson. And they just continue on their merry way. And I have it that that's their fifth goal of this quarter. Five goals to none in this quarter. They've put the foot down. 12-10-82. Saying 1-7-13, 82 playing 13. So we head towards time on in this third quarter. We're playing 19 minutes.
Gee, the Lions out to a 25-point lead against Sandringham. That would be huge result for Coburg. Not a good result for Hilly, but a wonderful result for Coburg as Harms trying to get his way through three tacklers. He can't. Ball spills the ground. They're still not coming out of this one anytime soon, and it'll be another ball up.
Certainly Sandringham, we're going to have somewhere around about the 16 to 18 St Kilda listed players today, so that's a huge effort from Coburg.
If they can sustain it.
Yeah, plenty to go there. Is there an injury there on the wing? We'll just keep an eye on that as Gent looks to be in a bit of strife. The Blues are marching on forward again. Long ball to the top of the square. It's missing. It carried the pack, but missed to the left. Gallucci couldn't get hands on it. So another behind for the Blues. Gent looks like he's up and going.
Yep.
So that's good news for Casey. as Kennedy Harris comes straight down the middle. Fritz in trouble. Fist from Keppel. Out the back, Kelty couldn't get a hold of it. Well played, Fritz. Got it away. And Neil Bullen was hoping for a teammate to be there in the end. It was okay for Munro, who goes down the line. Kick not his best as Shan's there to mop up. Left foot comes to Buckley, giving them some spark across half-back this afternoon. Goes to O'Shea, who's looking for Wilson, who gives a really strong lead and takes it slightly defensive side of centre wing. Going to go back across the ground. And that's okay for Boakhurst, who goes on his left. Nice kick. And they've switched again for Sheehan, who goes to Armfield, who's on the outer wing now. Goes down the ground and finds Lebois, who is still two kicks out from home, I reckon. And he's going to go on his left boot here and find his man, and that's Kerridge, who's kicked a goal this afternoon and had plenty of it. Drives it to the top of the square. There's no mark. Who's going to pick it up at the ground level? It's Ferreira. Drew Wilson got the handball away. Too slow to get away with it. No. Kick was okay in the end. McCready under all sorts of pressure from Scott. They go at it one-on-one, and now the cavalry arrives. They did well not to give a free kick away there, the Blues. Good disciplined footy. And the umpire will come in and toss it up.
Sean Dwyer's just been patched up, ready to head back out onto the field. He'll be wearing the number 33. He's also had to swap his jumper.
Power by 20 points over the Suns. Harms up against it here with Lamb for company. Never a horrible result if you're dining. Not so good on the footy field. They'll toss it in. Half forward flank, the Blues lead 12-11-83 to Casey 1-7-13.
So, all one-way traffic today. Forecheck, ruckwork duty, Harms. Kick partially smothered, plants of the umpire. Keppel going without it. Now here's Lamb, got three to beat, two to beat initially. Now the third, and it's holding the footy. Jed Lamb, it's Lucio Ferreira to take the free kick.
Pushing top five names in the VFL, Pete.
Like it. We'll have to compile a list before the season's out. That not a top five kick, unless it were bad ones. He went into the path there of Armfield, working into the path here of Kerr with the dribbling ball. Back to Armfield, who goes around his body. Boakhurst pushes it back. Keppel back to Boakhurst. Still on centre wing. Just working with Phillips. Back to Boakhurst. He's standing up here. He's got to get around the traffic of Gent and work there to O'Shea. Back to Boakhurst, who goes by end again. He should just keep running here. Well, the kick into the path of Armfield, who kicked into the player in front of him. Now has to go back and get the footy. There's a pack forming, and the umpire will come in and throw the ball up. Got about six or seven possessions there, Blaine Boakhurst.
Oh, hello.
Yeah, there's a little bit of push and shove. Dennis not liking the attention.
From Munro.
As the ball's tossed back up. Phillips getting the ball down. Wilson getting through some heavy traffic. He's kicked those turned over. Works to Harris, who kicks a high ball up back towards centre wing. Coming in there with the fist was Baker. Can't get away here, Casey, and they've turned it over. Now Wilson trying to put it in the path of O'Shea. He's turned it over. Kennedy picks it up. That's Kennedy for the Scorpions. But he's fumbled at the crucial moment, and they've turned it over again. Let's watch the Blues and see how they go moving this ball up the field, because they're so fast. The kick comes out. It's going to favour Lamb. Stretch on his hammer. Lamb takes the mark. He has to retreat back. Oh, the player already is only the goal square. Can't find him yet. The kick goes across the ground. Gorringe back to Lamb. Lamb works it into the hot spots. Oh, coming out to meet it there was Lebois. He picks it up, did really well. Now dragged down in the tackle by Dwyer, who goes back in again. Lebois did well, got to his feet. Oh, Boakhurst, he dropped it at the crucial moment. He was supposed to kick it. It's turned over, working their collis. He kicks across the ground, and they just hang on. They're just hanging on by their fingertips here, the Scorpions.
Blaine Boakhurst was just taken high there too, boys, and surprised the umpire missed it.
Casey have the footy, half-back flank Trengove. Looking for an option inboard. Not much doing. Little one over the top to Scott, who is dealt with by Cunningham. Cunningham happy not to give the 50 away. Casey fans pretty keen on that result. Now Scott's in trouble here. He's going to go long and across the ground. Has he measured it okay, Kaz? Well played. As Kerr was bearing down on Kennedy Harris, who heads further afield, asking a bit here of Gent and Moncrief, who had two to beat, hits Armfield on the way through over the line, and they will toss it back in. Half forward flank for the Blues. They lead 83-13. It's a neat 70 points at the moment. Power by 21 points over the Suns. Box Hill too good for Richmond earlier today. Richmond went down by 4 points from a kick after Byron. And Coburg look in control against Sandringham. 25 points to margin there in the third term. Here, Paulson working hard at ground level. Comes away to Bokhurst, who's having a picnic. He delivers beautifully inside the 50. Gallucci takes the mark. He's 45 out. He's got, I reckon he's a metre in from the boundary, perhaps less. So it'll take some kicking. But when you're a little fella and you get a mark and you're inside the 50, it sort of doesn't make sense to pass it off.
He has tended to kick on the inside of his foot here on these longer shots. Let's see if he gets to the outside. This time he does.
And he heads across the face. Ooh. Phillips is on the line, but it's over the line before he gets a hand on it, and it's one behind. 84 to 13, 21 minutes gone. Third turn.
Oh, Kennedy Harris handball to himself, and then fumbled on the goal line. Oh, gee, it's okay, though. He worked it out. Found Munro. It's called to play on. And now has to get around his opponent. Not convincingly, Neil Bullen was there. He kicks up towards centre wing. Jones comes in with the fist. Kennedy did okay. Handball across, Gent back to Kennedy Harris. So we start again. The kick into the middle of the ground. Ferreira, unmarked, takes the mark. He kicks across the ground. He's looking for Scott. Oh, plenty of Blues defenders around, but fumbling and then mucking around with the footy. Stretch has to go and pick up the footy. Did okay. Back to Scott. Scott throws it on the boot, and that works out okay. It was untidy. Fritch is there. He takes the mark.
Oh, they'll take an untidy goal just at the minute, Pete.
They'll take whatever they can get. They haven't scored a goal in this quarter, which is now 26 minutes old. 27 minutes old. A bit hard to tell with that old time clock on the other side of the ground. So, in he comes. Bailey Fritch. We'll go on the left and kicks the goal. Finally, the Demons have a goal in this quarter. They move to 2-7-19, playing 12-12-84. As we're ticking down to three-quarter time, 26, 27 minutes gone in this third quarter.
They've had winners all over the park today, the Blues, but that was a good reward for Fritch, who's worked quite hard.
Yes.
Yeah, done a few neat things. That's his eighth goal of the year in his fifth game, so he'll be happy with his contribution so far in 2017. Not sure he could do with some help. Casey back in the middle. Phillips knocks it down. Kennedy Harris busts away from the half back line. Kicks a long ball, hoping for a mark. And he gets one. No, not paid. Keppel did well at ground level. Swung it to the wing. Now Lebois to go toe to toe with Kennedy Harris. This will be a good contest. Kennedy Harris first there. He's tossed over the line. Good tackle from Lebois. And they will toss it in. Centre wing out of sight.
Bailey Fritch from Coldstream.
Very good brewery in that area of the world.
Is that how you rate your landmarks?
That one is, yes, it's recognisable and enjoyable, put it that way. Came to King.
Refreshing, seemingly.
Harms, long ball inside the 50. He won't find anyone on a mark. Out the back, who's going to have the pace? It's Keppel who read it best. He gets the handball away. Sheehan's there to relieve. Left foot, nice kick. And he finds O'Shea. And a former Port Adelaide player comes in board and finds his target. Cunningham's been good. I like the way he's gone about it in his early career for the Blues. He's going to go with a nice short ball here to Lebois, who's got plenty of X factor, and he's got the foot in his hands at half back. Left foot, good kick. And Armfield has it at half back. Looking for something across the ground. He runs and draws Fritch and then gives the handball away. Crucial ball to Wilson in the middle. Took it beautifully on the bounce and then gives the handball to the run of Armfield, who kept going. Buckley's going to take the mark at half back. What can he do for the Blues here? Stops, props, asked to play on, so he goes with a short ball, and that's okay for Lamb. He's barking instructions with the pill in his hand. Wants some movement. There's nothing initially.
Cunningham's been on his own for 35 seconds.
He's going to bomb this long. Wants a mark. Phillips has three to beat, and he does. Oh, they're on today, the Blues. And now look at them streaming forward. Oh, the siren's going to beat another brace for the Blues. They had three men full to their Casey opponents. And it'll count for precious little now. But the scoreboard is still very ugly for Casey. The Northern Blues 12-12-84. Casey 2-7-19.
So in that quarter, they kicked 5-3 to 1-1, the Blues. And they have extended their margin. They are flying along. It's 65-3-quarter time. The goal kickers to three-quarter time. 4 to Christian Jacks, 3 to Liam Sumner, and 2 to Cam Polson. Singles to Wilson, Armfield, and Lavoie. And for Casey, singles, Fritsch and Kennedy Harris. It makes tough reading if you're a Casey fan, but for the Northern Blues, well in front at this stage. 65 points the margin. Final quarter coming up next. Stay with us here on Peter Jackson, VFL Live.
Love your sport? Then you'll love SEN.
Looks to be the last game of the first set. Our Mugger leading 5-3.
And you'll find it on digital radio. Simply scroll to SEN, Melbourne's home of sport.
I'm a digital radio. To help explain why it's time to update your old radio, with me is my friend Digital TV.
Hi.
Where you go?
Remember when us TVs went digital?
Everyone does. Get to the point.
Suddenly, you got lots more channels for free.
Yes.
Well, it's the same with digital radio.
When you buy a digital radio, you can get all your favourite stations, plus up to 30 extra ones, playing all kinds of music, live, sport and talk.
That's pretty great.
It's really great.
All you have to do is head into your nearest retailer.
Or check out digitalradioplus.com.au.
And upgrade to digital.
Last year, Vision Australia helped more than 33,000 people who are blind or have low vision. So if you find that glasses are no longer helping and you're struggling to complete daily tasks, why not give us a call? Our free services, provided by specialist staff, can help increase your independence. We also offer advice on equipment and provide training in how to travel around safely with limited vision. Vision Australia can help you make a real difference. Call us now, 1300 847 4666.
The Red Time Sport iPhone app is here and ready to download. The app allows you to listen to the different sports BPM media broadcasts wherever you are in the world, including VFL and TAC Cup Radio and a whole lot more. You can interact with the commentary team in real time via the Red Time Sport iPhone app feedback and social networking buttons. Plus, check out upcoming broadcasts. Catch up with the latest sports headlines from around the world via the Sports News button. The Red Time Sport iPhone app. Download it from the iTunes Store today. Visit bpmmedia.com.au for more details.
I'm a digital radio.
And I'm a digital TV. Now, you may remember when TV went digital.
Yes, yes, and you got a lot more channels and a better picture.
Well, buying a digital radio is the same.
Exactly. I've got up to 30 extra radio stations, plus all your old faves, and I sound amazing.
Yeah, but I look amazing.
Yeah, but this is a radio ad, so no one can see you.
Oh, yeah.
So if you want to hear this station like you have never heard it before,
buy a digital radio.
Head into your nearest retailer and upgrade to digital.
Next week, Peter Jackson VFL Live is at Burbank Oval for the Round 6 clash between Williamstown and Richmond. That's next Sunday afternoon from 1:45, live on the Red Time Sport iPhone app and audio and video stream through vfl.com.au.
Peter Jackson VFL Live, online, on digital radio and the Red Time Sport iPhone app.
And back here at Preston City Oval, well, the home side, they're pretty darn happy with the way things are going. The Northern Blues 12-12-84, Casey 2-7-19. Let's go with a big wrap-up of all the around-the-ground scores from today, because there is plenty happening. Let's go around the AFL grounds first, and then we'll update you with what's happening at Piranha Park.
All right, Richmond fans, I'm sure your hearts are breaking tonight. Fremantle by 2 points from a goal after the siren from David Mundy gets Fremantle to win at the MCG. Across just a little while away in Shanghai, Gold Coast 117 show Port Adelaide by 21 points early on in the second term. Box Hill were too good for Richmond in the VFL after trailing by 30 points in the second term, came back to win and win convincingly. And in the other game between Coburg and Sandringham, it was Coburg by 25 points in the third term. We're just waiting on an update from that match, and we will keep you up to date as soon as it comes through. But that would be a huge result if the Lions can get on the board with a win against Sandringham.
Yeah, just trying to get that score there, and obviously Box Hill getting the win over Richmond. So a double whammy for the Tiger fans today. Well beaten by Box Hill. They're overrunning that second half, and then, well, that match at the MCG. But anyway, And here it is all the Blues, and they're just rolling along nicely. They've got Sandringham coming up in their next couple of weeks, and then Footscray at home in what will be a big clash. And they're slowly bringing things back here. Sandringham, the goal back there at Coburg. We'll bring you three-quarter time score when it comes to hand.
Interested to hear what Hilly has to say at three-quarter time. Not much that Justin Platt can do really to fix this situation. It's not a fun place to be as a football club when you're down by an irretrievable margin at three-quarter time. We've won one game so far this year. We're at round five, and this is not a pretty position for Justin Platt to find himself in.
Not when you got Port Melbourne next week.
No, it doesn't fill you with confidence.
Certainly holding them for a long time, the Blues, and Josh Fraser has finished his message and the boys are back into position. You can hear the clapping in the background. Hilly, whenever you're ready, Hilly, you've got Justin Platt with you.
Thanks, boys. Yeah, Justin's been good enough to give me some time. It's been a tough day at the office today, mate. Obviously. What I was going to lead to was what can we look for in the last quarter given the tough day?
I just spoke to the boys about personal pride, and you know they haven't played their best footy. We're disappointed with our effort to start with. So look, you know, we've been outplayed, we've been out muscled, we've been out contested, everything in all areas of the game, and the indicators are really really strong around that. So it's probably a little bit of personal pride now. Yeah.
Also, you mentioned at three-quarter time the uncontested marks was hovering around about that 60 mark, and obviously that's not acceptable in today's game.
Yeah, look, the way that we want to defend, it's unacceptable, and you know, minus 60 at any level is pretty ordinary. So it's one of the challenges. We want to try and take their marks away and try and get some credit really back into our game, because it's certainly one of our poorer performances we had for a long time.
Also, too, Angus Brayshaw going down didn't help to start the game, and obviously there's been a few head clashes throughout the game as well, which have caused some problems on the boundary line for you.
Yeah, no, it is. I mean, we've sort of had a bit of a consistent theme with losing blokes early in games. We lost Maynard early last week, we lost Brayshaw. The week before it was Brayshaw again. So, look, it throws you out a little bit. It's disappointing for him, but, you know, hopefully he's okay, and, you know, we'll deal with it. We'll fight back and we'll go again. So,
look. Look, great positive attitude. Thanks for joining us in a tough day.
Hilly down there with Justin Platt on the boundary line. Now make his way up to the commentary box. And, well, let's see what they can do in this final quarter.
Cunningham comes away for the Blues. Heads to the outer flank. Gets knocked away by Hutchins against Jackson. There's a man with some pride. Don't worry about that. In case he's skipper. Been around the block once or twice and seen some good wins and some bad losses too over the journey. Part of it, of course, the VFL from week to week and year to year is such a different prospect. And for the Blues, they're going nicely. Russell got it from Wilson around the corner. Hewlett went early. Moncrief couldn't bring it down. Little kick forward for Kerr out the back. Armfield handball looking for, but couldn't find his teammate there, Bokhurst, and it was taken away by Kennedy Harris. He got it to half back where Kennedy knocks it out. Well played, Gent, just volleyballed it forward. And now on the end of it, Harms. He got it down the line to Neil Bullen. Had some support out the back, Scott, but it's stolen by McCready. Beautifully played. Under pressure, though, and that was well played. Munro, who gets it away to Neil Bullen, but the umpires said, I'll take that, gentlemen. Might have been Munro through the middle a moment ago, who was trying to break a line and get something going for the score, for the Demons. Just haven't brought their best footy today. Toss back in. Kilty got it down to Stretch. Well tackled. Ball spilt free. Chance for Kennedy Harris, who's really attacked the footy pretty well today. Arms is there. Big smother from Buckley. Heard that in the effect. Mike Scammell will be happy with the effects there. That was good. As Wilson works hard at ground level. As though we were there.
Oh, thudded into Dylan Buckley.
84-19, early going, final term.
So Korchek over the back and finds some space as Bokhurst right near the boundary line. Sumner just trying to go the one-hander, set Russell a task. He's driven into the turf. He went forward and should be pick-folding the ball, and he's took a couple of steps, and that was it. Number 13 being Munro will take it to Kennedy Harris. Twisting and turning on centre wing. A little bit too easy around Jacks there as he kicks up the line here. Kennedy Harris up toward the 50, and that's turned over again. As we go sort of a bit of kick-to-kick sort of stuff. So Boakhurst on defensive 50. He's sort of dancing around in a circle, and now it's hugging the boundary line. Korchek, almost the mark at the front position. Punched out of his hands by Moncrief, who hasn't been the worst player for the KC side today, Leedsy.
Coburg get one right on three-quarter time. They lead 75-59 against Sandringham, an upset brewing there.
All right, keep close eye on that as we continue along here at the Preston City Oval. Earlier, a win for Box Hill over Richmond. Ball off hands, Cunningham, second and third efforts, excellent off to Boakhurst. Little short chipping ball, Gorringe, the man in the middle, sends Kerridge running across here to Wilson, who kicks inside the 50, and Kerr takes the mark. Excellent transfer all the footy, clean transfer all of the footy by the Blues, and Kerr should go back and slot this. And kicked a goal today. I suspect that he might be about to rectify that now. He prepares, taking plenty of time over the kick too. Early stages, final term. As he comes in, and that's across the face. One behind, 12, 13, 85. Playing 2, 7, 19. As the Scorps, well, been untidy coming out of defence. Options have been few and far between. Kick from Kennedy Harris, almost the mark to Kilty. Is it going to be paid? It will be. It will come back. McCready standing the mark. He calls a deck in the background. Comes up the line. Big flyers from everyone. Jones was at the back. He wasn't the biggest of the flyers. That's a bit of a surprise. Buckley. They're just going to mop up here. Sheehan back to Buckley. Cross the defensive goal square, go the Blues to Kerridge, back out to defensive 50, and Kerr, who's made up a lot of ground, takes the mark, dealt with at the end by Johnston, and he gets to his feet now, Paddy Kerr.
Just on the defensive arc as he goes over the top, nice kick through the hands there in the end, and now it's going to be a turnover, left foot inside the 50, nicely weighted for Fritsch from Scott, and the kick will come from 50, 45 degree angle. So, as we've discussed a couple of times, looks the player, young Bailey Fritz. There's a man running past, but he's...
That's not going to happen.
No, that's just silly stuff, that is. From just inside the arc, left foot kick is on its way. Beautiful hit. A third of the afternoon. Takes them to 3-7-25. Even 60 points behind the Northern Blues, 12-13-85. We've gone 8.5 minutes in this final term, and it is all the Blues.
Justin Platt asked for some personal pride to be in the forefront of their minds in this last quarter, and they've certainly come out with some aggression.
Well, they have. A bit of intent, although fair to say the heat has well and truly gone out of the game. Interesting side note from over there at Coburg for St Kilda fans as the ball back in the middle here. Kilty straight down though to Paulson, who kicks a long ball inside the 50. Kerr got hands to it, couldn't complete the mark. Ball dribbling forward. Jacks kicked plenty today. Handball back, looking for Sumner, couldn't find him. Wilson coming through. He lost a handle on it. Grim defending here from the Demons, and the umpire will come in and throw it up. Deep into attack for the Blues.
Yeah, Nathan Freeman hasn't returned to play after being injured. No confirmation on whether or not he's suffered concussion.
Word coming through from the club. The tap down ends up with Wilson, who's had plenty of time with it. And it's holding the footy. Yeah, plenty of opportunity there. There's the ball coming out dangerously. Oh, second, third, Hams twice was brought down. Still managed to get the handball away. Let's see what they can do, working their way out of defence. It's Munro, finds Tringove on his own on centre wing, drop what he should have taken. The umpire actually blew the whistle to indicate the mark. It was that easy. I couldn't believe it. Anyway, it's out of bounds on the full. And it'll be Tringove, luckily, to take the free kick. They still have the ball here, Casey. But that's just taking your eye off the footy. And it's basically summing up the day. 85 plays 25. As the kick goes up the line, up towards half forward. The big fist there from Phillips. It goes to the back. Sheehan trying to go the handball in the Jones direction. It's being Kyle. Ferreira coming through. Kicks inside the 50. Having to go one-handed there was Kennedy. Surprised the ball went that far. Back to stretch. Handball across. Dangerous footy. Trying to pick it up into the path of Johnston. He was brought down. Jones having to do the defending. Now the ball spills free. Working hard here. Cunningham did well. Kerridge works it across to O'Shea. O'Shea's got some space. Then Correll by stretch. They worked it back. Wilson back to Kerridge. Handball over the top. He's going to be cut off. Moncrief getting in the way. Ball near the line. We'll have it thrown in just forward of centre for the Blues, who lead this 85-25. We've played 10 minutes in the final quarter.
One-way traffic today, and it's been terrific traffic for Blues fans. They must have enjoyed what they've seen from both the AFL and the VFL in 2017 so far, as Paulson busts a line, gets through traffic, got it away. That was a good stuff to Sumner, who set a task here for Gallucci. Knows he has pace, so he just set it out in front of him. Got away from Kennedy Harris, gave the handball to Bokehurst. Little ball inside the 50 to Armfield, comes back to Bokehurst. Little short kick. He's okay for Jax, who takes the mark. Five in from the boundary with 40 to cover.
Did anyone actually want to play on Blaine Bokehurst there, the Casey defenders? No one going to. He could have gone left, he could have gone right.
Also, Hutchins just left Jax completely free for the best part of 40 seconds there. He was free the entire time.
So Jax has four to his name before this kick on goal, little left. 12-14-86 to 3-7-25, 11 and a half gone. Final term. It's all about the margin here. Cross at Sandringham, three-quarter time. Coburg by 25 points.
Yeah, let's see what happens there. Could be a big win coming up for the Lions as the kick outside the 50. Kick. Got hands to it. Couldn't bring it down. Hillard there as well. Coming through Vanderhaar, 23rd play today for the Demons. And they've turned it over. Jax getting through traffic. Finds Paulson. His kick heading up to the top of the goal square. Kerr just outmarked. This is what we wanted to see early on from Casey. Moncrief taking the defensive mark. He's been good today, except that kick. A little double grabber there. One-handed sort of style from Kerridge. He takes the mark. He's 60 from goal. Called to play on by the umpire. So just going to load it up. Long, high ball. Jax flew high over the top of the pack. Couldn't bring it down. Now Kerr laying the tackle. Ball spills free. Ends up with Gallucci to Lamb. Puts it up towards the top of the goal square. And a good mark, Neil Bullen. Was important early for the Demons. Play it down behind play two in the contest.
It's Todd Vanderhaar.
It is. He's still on his haunches. Kick across the ground. Hewlett in the back pocket. Vanderhaar in the hands of one of the trainers there. Kick going sort of in his general direction. There's the ball here. Oh, dear. Another skill error as they try and exit the 50 here. The Demons, the kick in the Tringove direction. Second, third, fourth efforts. Couldn't bring it down. And now the turnover. Cunningham. Oh, they're chopping them up. Here's Sumner. He takes the mark in the pocket. He squares it up. That mark is just barely the distance. And Jax will have another shot at goal. He's kicked four today. And he'll line up from 35 out to at number five.
Judging by the grimace on Todd's face and the smile that came across the trainer's face when they were in attendance and found out what had happened, say he might have caught one where he would have preferred not to have.
Yep. As Jax comes in, that's a beautiful kick. He's had a day out today. And that is goal number five for Christian Jax. 13th on the board, 13-14-92. To 3 goals, 7-25. It is a very one-sided result. Speaking of results, what's happening over in Shanghai?
Getting a little one-sided over there in Shanghai, 52-11. Westhoff just kicked the goal from the pocket to extend that lead to a very comfortable 41-point margin.
So commanding lead here for the Blues. It's the Lions leading at Piranha Park.
Keep an eye on that one. Oh, McCartan's just kicked his fourth, and it's back to a 9-point margin, an 11-point margin, I should say. Interesting game developing here. Casey try and come away with it. Inside the 50, there's not going to be a mark. Blues had all the numbers in the air. Ball at ground level. Carrera got it away. Only just to Munro. Was he taken high or did he duck? Umpire said he ducked, and I was with the umpire. They'll toss it up, 50 out directly in front.
Good to see this quarter, though, Casey, taking the game on more. I know there's been a few skill errors, but they're certainly taking the game on.
Oh, here they come away from the pack. Harms was dynamic, got it away for Kennedy. He was well tackled by Keppel. They're going nowhere, and the umpire will ping them. Wow. So it'll be a Blues ball, back pocket. 15 gone, final term. It's all about the margin here for a Blues team that are playing some good footy in 2017. This kick not the best. Kennedy picks up the crumbs, got it away to Collis. Inside the 50, finds his man. And that is Sean Dwyer, who's now wearing a bandage in number 33 after having to come off with a blood rule. He'll kick from 20 out on a 45 degree angle. And he should add his side's fourth of the afternoon. Heard Justin Clapp. He was so generous with his time at three-quarter time, and Dwyer has kicked the goal. Spoke about that personal pride, and good to see Dwyer coming back on and doing the job by putting it through the middle. So 13-14-92, the Northern Blues to the Casey Demons, 4-7-31. 15 and a half gone in this final term. And Hilly, great access to the coaches here in the Peter Jackson VFL live coverage, and to be being beaten the way they are, and Justin didn't just fob you off. He was happy to talk to you for a good couple of minutes, even after the ball had been bounced. It was remarkable access.
Oh, fantastic! And Justin is certainly one of the better coaches in the competition for giving his time, and every opportunity we do get to cover a Casey game, he certainly is A1.
It's ball here in the middle, going nowhere. The umpire will throw it back up.
Yeah, it just gives such good access to Casey and Melbourne fans to hear that.
Certainly, and it's always tough on a day like today where the game is done and dusted at three-quarter time, but it really was good of him to spend the extra time and just run through some of the points of the game.
Now, we're on the point of the square attacking side for the Demons, but there's been a push in the back, and the free kick will go the Blues' way to Cunningham. There's his kick. Go that out of sight, he'll find Wilson. Looks up and doesn't see a heck of a lot ahead, but may as well just push it forward. As the tall timber flies, Gorringe there trying to create the contest. Harms for the Demons, handballing over his head indiscriminately. Working well in close quarters was Hillard. Now they've got some run through the middle. A long ball into the path of goal. It's been picked up by Fritch again. And the boy from Coldstream puts through his third.
Had a good game.
He's had a very good game on what's been a tough day for the Casey Scorpions. Three goals
Demons.
Out of the Casey Demons. Oh, I knew I'd do it eventually. Three goals out of their five.
You're not on an island.
They're still a long way back. When you call teams few and far between, if you get their name, that's okay. You know it's Casey anyway. There's a blood rule going to happen here. I think Dwyer's going to come off again.
Yeah, it's just a rebandage required on the scone. Yeah, 10 for the year so far for Fritch. So this is his fifth game. He has had an impact for Casey, no doubt about that.
Better give the score. 13-14-92 to 5-7-37. Midway through this final quarter, we've ticked through 17 minutes. There's the ball back in the middle. We'll get you a score, hopefully get you a score from
down 9 points. The margin was the last one we've got. Oh, nice bounce in the middle here. Look at that. umpires really get their credence when they're delivering that sort of stuff. Gent goes inside the 50, knocked away. Here's Fritch again. Little handball, looking for Ferreira. They've got some numbers around the footy, but Wilson, his dogged determination around the pill there, and he got his man. That was Stretch. We'll go again. Wilson, as captain of the Blues, committed in every single way, including his footwear, and he's working hard again at ground level, making sure this doesn't come away through Stretch. He's around the pack again here, the skipper. It just went past his right mitt as it hits the deck. Now some disciplined tackling from the Blues. Nothing coming out. Now Wilson picks up the footy. It's his turn to be dumped in a tackle. A little bit of feeling in that one too. As might be Munro again involved in some physical stuff. Bokhurst lurking around here. Nicely knocked down by Korchek, got it away, and yeah, that was a free kick out the back, not played, so Casey come away with it. Long ball to the top of the square, but Jones takes the mark and then darts away from half back. Nicely weighted kick, beautifully weighted kick, and wonderful hands from Sam Kerridge, who takes it at half back. He steers it into the path of Lamb, back to Kerridge. Oh, awkward bounce. There he was beset upon. Mitch Gent might have got him high. Umpire said, holding the footy. So it's a Casey Bull, centre wing, right in front of our commentary position here. And it's 92-37 as we approach time on in the last quarter.
Mitch Gent, who comes back to Casey after a stint at Noble Park. Long-time player for this club. Plays some suburban footy now back in the Peter Jackson VFL. There's a ball here fisted away from Kennedy towards the line. We'll have it thrown in. On 50 for the Demons, 92 playing 37 as we head towards time on in this final quarter. It's going to be a thumping win to the Northern Blues today, and that's four in a row. That's their opening game to Port Melbourne, who are undefeated, and push out here in the ruck contest. A free kick will go the way of Korchek. Now they lost to Port and then won three games, now make today four. Here with Buckley to Wilson. Goes back, Bokhurst. That's not the siren, unfortunately. That's the, what is it, the 4:22 to on the way to South Morang, Bar, Preston Station. It's a kick out wide for O'Shea.
Be a few people hoping that was the siren, Pete.
Yep. Kicking short, Bokhurst across to Wilson.
Not us.
Chipping around the 50. Maybe not you, as the kick here for Buckley. And he takes it at half-back.
Not Healy.
You know where he's going to interview. Good players all over the ground today for the Blues. The kick
not
going
get a touch
up
here.
The line. Korchek, wrong mark. Takes it over the top of Hillard. In front of Healy. Oh, that's confusing. Works there to Bokhurst, who kicks inside the 50. Hatchett's front position. Couldn't bring it to ground. Gallucci's there. Sumner handballs in front of Gallucci. Paddling in front of him. Hewlett brought him down. It's right near the behind post. And it goes over. Out of bounds on the full, I think. Yeah, the boundary umpire was, and the goal umpire conferring. It'll be a free kick going the way of Cunningham.
Quick around the ground score. 13 points the margin, 81-68, 11 minutes played in the last quarter. Coburg in front of Sandringham.
We're well ahead of that game. As Cunningham doing 16 today. We'll try and bend it around. And I think he's got it. He has. Oh, that's a good kick. There wasn't much excitement from anyone, really. He brought it back beautifully.
Not sure that the Casey players were all that happy with that being called a goal. There was
14-14-98 playing 5-7-37. No score reviews in the Peter Jackson VFL. It looked to me like it was just going to shoot across the face.
He might have just hit it perfectly.
Well, he did. So we tick down to full time. We've played 22 minutes in the final quarter, and it's a big win coming up. I think it'd be just reward, I think, Leeds, if the Northern Blues kick another goal and get to the 100.
Yes, yeah, they deserve that and more. It's been some sort of performance as Paulson comes away from the middle. Here's a chance, long ball inside the 50, but The Demons have the numbers, and it's going to be taken away nicely across the halfback, flanked by Moncrief. He found his teammate. Tringo's going to bang it long down the wing. Wants a mark. Oh, Jones crashed the pack. Did well. Knocked it down. Wilson quickly away on the end of it here. A chance for the Blues out the back. Wilson gets it back. They're still under a little bit of pressure, but just got it away in the nick of time. And this foray forward is going to be ultimately over the line, and they'll toss it in. 98-37. Closing stages of this one. Justin Clapp, you heard tell Glenn Hill at three-quarter time that he wanted a performance befitting of some men with some personal pride. And I think Casey have given him that in the last term. Again, that's the train, not the siren. As a long ball in from O'Shea for the Blues, gives them a chance at that 100 mark. Hewlett knocks it away from Hillard over the line, and they will toss it in. 4.5 metres around from the point post. The market end of Preston City Oval. Chance for the Blues to go to work again. Who's likely here? Cunningham's around. Had a couple of fleet-footed forwards. Armfield trying to come in. Couldn't take it. Paulson went hard but went without the footy. Bokhurst is there, but it's all Casey as Tringove gets a left foot kick outside the 50. Ball hits the deck. Now who's going to pick it up cleanly? Out the back, McCready has been pretty impressive. Chance for Sheehan, who paddles towards the line. There's some tired bodies out the back. Oh. Little kick forward from Harms, only a metre. Sheehan was in the way. He forgot that he had an opponent there, Harms. And they pile on for holding the ball. Casey ball at the wing. What can they muster here?
Could have been very dangerous for Kieran Sheehan too.
Kennedy Harris kicks the half forward, and there was only one man within 10 metres of the drop of that ball, and unfortunately he plays for the Blues. Kerridge, is that a big day really? Comes across the ground. Lamb's been pretty impressive too. Rare that that's not the case as Pickett takes it, centre wing, over the top, and that's good stuff from Hewlett. Got a fist in against Kerr, and they'll toss it in right in front of Hilly, riding boundary side for us this afternoon. You've just joined us. Wasn't a good start to the day for Casey. Angus Brayshaw off in the first minute with concussion, and we haven't seen him since. Jones in the ruck, knocked it down looking for Wilson. In the end, it came back to him. He's got to go back to work to Kerridge, and there's a little fist on the partitions down on the boundary line. Hasn't been a good day. You can understand the frustrations across the ground for the visitors.
Oh, getting closer at Coburg. 82 play 75.
Ooh.
Ben Long kicks a goal.
Jeez.
16 minutes into the final quarter there.
Quickly away for Dwyer to half forward, but a nice mark by McCready, and he steadies the ship for the Blues.
7-point margin at Parada Park. The kick is dangerous. Oh, Balsadie's head taken off. We'll take the free kick. Not one of the more obvious ones you'll see. It was Vanderhaar, very crude there. Let's kick up here into the path of Kerridge from the contest. It's off hands. Going in there, Dwyer for Casey. Wilson at the bottom of the pack. And the skipper, they're just holding the footy up for the Blues. Munro gets to his feet and ball's tossed back up. Kennedy, Tringove, kick looking in the path of Fritsch, takes the mark. On his bike is Alex Neil Bullen. The kick goes that way. It's going to suit him. He's got the opportunity now. Dribbling ball. He's going to get a free kick anyway. The ball is going to come back. There's a touch of the what did I do's about all of that, but Neil Bullen was on his bike, and the bloke who's been pretty good today, Christian Jacks, he's just decided to just have a bit of a run down back.
Sending a message to the coach that he doesn't want to be put in a defensive 50 again.
Yeah. So in he comes. Neil Bullen makes no mistake. 6-7-43, playing 14-14-98, closing in on full time here at the Preston City Oval. I'll tell you what, Hilly, we might need to turn the lights on. It's getting awfully dark, awfully quick.
It certainly is, boys. Just don't have a think about who to approach. What are your thoughts? Who's been best on ground today?
Well, this is a tough decision. I was going to throw that to you to work out who the best person to speak
probably
to
got
is.
About four or five off the top of my head at the moment.
Jax, who played great games. Cunningham's been okay. Bokehurst, good. Paulson, Kerridge in particular. Wilson, the skipper.
Buckley.
Oh, 1-point ball game at Piranha Park too, by the way.
One of those Lions
Paddy McCart's
fans.
Kicked another goal. 20 minutes gone at Piranha Park.
Save a thought for the Lion fans trying to get on the board in 2017 against the might of an AFL Lion club. They're holding on just. Ball kick towards the line here. Now, is this going to be called deliberate? It is not. 98-43 here, 30 minutes gone. Hilly just working out who he's going to get to it. The final siren.
The skipper, maybe?
Plenty of good players out there today. It
certainly has. There's probably been a good 13 or 14 clear winners on the ground. So
it's like a buffet for post-match interviews for Hilly. Korchek against King. Knockdown, Kennedy, Trengo, stretch. Nicely done from halfback until that man Kerridge, who's been a very good player, Hilly.
He has. He's had
it in the middle of the ground.
Had a lot of football today, as have a lot of the midfielders for the Blues.
Short ball. Okay. Oh, good effort. And Lamb's really worked his way into it too. You know what? If he's going to get the free kick, he should really have a barrel here. And he's calling for it. And I like that sort of stuff. To get them to 100, 14-14, 98-6, 7-43. Before Lamb takes the kick from, I reckon, around 75 out. He's just two steps. He didn't even give it any love. If you're going to have a go, you may as well have a real go.
That's a point.
Oh, two for a point.
No, I think that was fisted through by a Blues player, which means it's no score. So that is the final score here at Preston City Oval. It's a big win for the Blues. They're marching on in 2017. 14-14, 98. To the KC Demons, 6-7-43. The final margin, 55 points. And the Blues have four in a row after losing in round one to Port. Here's the song.
The goal kickers to full time. Five goals for Christian Jacks today. Three to Liam Sumner and two to Cam Paulson. Singles to Wilson, Armfield, Cunningham and LeBois. And for Casey, three goals to Bailey Fritch and singles the rest. Neil Bullen, Kennedy Harrison, Dwyer. They led by 21 points at quarter time, 39 at half time, 65 at three quarter time. And they end up running out 55 point winners.
I think Hilly's got one of their better players too.
Leedsy, joined by Blaine Bokehurst. Mate, it was a fantastic win today.
Yeah, the boys, we come out early and got the runs on the scoreboard, so we applied good pressure, stuck to our system, and that normally holds us in good stead.
Certainly, it's been really noticeable this season has been your sprint from the clearances, and I thought you excelled in that today.
Yeah, I just worked over that over the pre-season. I say bring your strengths to the game, so it's one of my strengths. And it's starting to pay off a bit.
Your bigger players as well dominated the air today. It would have made you feel good at the feet anyway.
Yeah, now the big boys always give us a good contest at the in the air. So, like all teams, we have a big focus on that. Bring the ball to the front and let the mids and the small forwards get to work.
Also, too, the run and carry off half back was really good. It set you up very early in the game when the game was in the balance in that first quarter. You float back towards the back line and then play through the midfield throughout the game, and you enjoy the run.
Yeah, it's just part of the plan we have, you know, get around the boys and help out back there, but with our good defence and our good system, that allows us to do that. So when we keep that structure right, we get results.
Well, you're off to a great start to the season. Continue the good work, and we'll speak to you later in the season.
Thanks, mate.
Blaine Bokehurst there with Glenn Hill. The Blues in a huddle in the middle of the ground. The Casey side trudging off. Well, they got the job done in that final quarter. They won the final quarter, so I guess that's the positive, I guess, to take out of today. So they kicked four goals straight to two goals two in that final term. We'll see if we can get the song from down in the rooms. We keep you close on everything that's happening around the place. Let's update all the other scores from around the place. It's tied at the moment, 82 apiece at Piranha Park. They'll be closing in on full time there. Scores are level, 82 apiece. So we'll keep you up to date with that as the Blues players make their way down underneath the grandstands here. Be very happy with their start to the season. And they sit 4-1 on the Peter Jackson VFL ladder. And they get the applause from the faithful as well. There's a couple of good jobs and pats on the back and all sorts of things going on there. As they make their way down underneath, they've kicked a goal, another goal, Sandy. Daniel McKenzie's kicked that goal. They lead by a goal now, 24 and a half minutes into the final quarter. As we're going to do our very little best to try and bring you this song. It's always a hit and miss proposition. So, Philly, if you stay right there. Let's see how we go with this song, Blues fans. I'm not liking our chances. We don't even need the microphone. We can hear it from down underneath the grandstand. There you go, Blues fans. Wasn't the whole lot, but you got the gist of it anyway. Thank you, Hilly. You can come back from the rooms. 55 points, the final score here at the Preston City Oval, and the Northern Blues just flying here at the start of the season, Peter Jackson VFL season. Earlier today, a big win for Box Hill coming from behind to defeat Richmond today at the Box Hill City Oval. And we're just looking to see if we can get a final score for you. At Piranha Park, they were closing in on full time. Sandringham leading by a goal, 13-10-88 to 13-4-82. Let's get some AFL scores. Yeah, the final earlier. One from the Richmond Fremantle earlier today.
Yeah, 2 points the margin to finish off Richmond. Unfortunately for Tiger fans, it was a kick after the siren from David Mundy that got the job done. And in the other game that's going on, it's Port Adelaide 10-5-65 to the Suns 3-5-23. North host Sydney, that one not far away. And in the VFL, as we mentioned, Box Hill got across Richmond after trailing by 30 points in the second term. And here, the Northern Blues way too good for Casey. We're just waiting on that final score to come in from Coburg and Sandringham. Coburg had put in a monstrous effort, but look like they might just go down by a goal late on in the final term.
Trying to find out whether that final score is coming through. It was Daniel McKenzie that kicked the goal for Sandringham to put them in front. But we'll wait on that final score to come through. But in the meantime, pretty complete performance, you'd have to say, from the Northern Blues today.
Yeah, I think there's a lot to like. The win is one thing, but one thing we've seen throughout the year, I mean, even that loss to Port, their organisation across the board is really impressive. So if you're a team and the Blues get the footy inside their 50, it is bloody hard work to get it out of there. They've really organised themselves. They've got some run, and Dash Hilly spoke about that effect in the first quarter. They've got some blokes who break the lines, Buckley and Boakhurst. Wilson's doing a great job at the coalface. And yeah, I reckon there's a lot to like about them. And I think for the first time, you know, in some time, there's probably an anticipation now that they will go on and not only play finals, but be competitive at the sharp end of the season.
Yeah, been a while for the Blues faithful to have some sort of hope like this at VFL level.
Yeah, it certainly has, Pete. And from what we've seen of the Blues so far this season, they have improved out of sight. And players, AFL players that were recruited to Carlton, who are currently in the Northern Blues, they've lifted, and you know, they're in their second season, for example, with the Blues, and they've probably improved 20% on what they were producing last year, and it's really obvious. They've got, you run down their lineup at the moment, and
there's just winners all over the park. Dylan Buckley's controlling the half-back line. Cam O'Shea's been a handy addition. Liam Jones probably playing some of the best football he's played at VFL level. Andrew Phillips, fantastic
in
the ruck.
Coming back from injury, hasn't he?
Jared Pickett behind the ball today was another winner. And that might be a little move that will suit his game.
Yep.
Christian Jacks absolutely just dominated the air today. Dennis Armfield led from the front with his courage and his experience.
Well, that's the key, I think, the experience that he brings to the table.
I think the other thing, boys, is the guys that are missing out. I mean, Strawn, Russell, Stevens, who was the other one I thought? Stavrou, you know.
Yeah.
These guys, there's some serious depth. It's not like they're going to be too short if they lose one or two along the journey.
They've kicked another goal here, Sandringham. 14-10-94 to 13-4-82. They're in front by two goals now. Ben Long kicking that goal for Sandringham. So they're home now. 29 minutes gone in that final quarter.
One of my favourite VFL players.
Ben Long, absolutely.
Yeah, he's a ripper, isn't he? It's heartbreaking for the Coburg side, though.
So... yep, Sandringham going to get the win there. Earlier today it was Box Hill, and here it was the Northern Blues. Next week at Eureka Stadium, next Saturday, North Ballarat taking on Werribee. At Piranha Park, Coburg take on Essendon, local derby there. Back here at the Preston City Oval, another home game for the Northern Blues. Take on Sandringham, an interesting contest that one. The Channel 7 game, Footscray versus Geelong at the VU Witten Oval. At the Holden Centre, Collingwood taking on the Box Hill Hawks. 45 starts ahead of the Collingwood Hawthorn game at the MCG. And then on Saturday night, Casey Field sees Casey taking on Port Melbourne. And our match for broadcast, it's a standalone Sunday game. It's Williamstown taking on Richmond from Burbank Oval. That's a 2 o'clock start. We're on air from 1:45. It's been a big day here. Thank you, Hilly.
No problems.
Thank you, Leedsy.
See you, Pete.
We'll catch you again next Sunday. For all the latest news during the week, vfl.com.au is the place to go. The VFL Rewind tomorrow night on 3WBC 94.1 and during the week on vfl.com.au. And we'll catch you again next Sunday from Burbank Oval. It's Williamstown and Richmond as Peter Jackson VFL season continues.